Last spring, the Philadelphia Flyers had the final say in the playoffs. This year, the Rangers have committed themselves to erasing that memory, throwing everything they've got in the way of Eric Lindros. The strategy has been draining on the 6'4" star, and his team has scored only once in two games versus New York. First, they met 4 days before Christmas when Jeff Bookaboom had a breakaway game-winning goal. Rangers 2, Flyers 1. Then on the 13th of this month, Classic Messier in a dominating 4-0 win. It has for now dispelled any notion that the Rangers couldn't match the size and strength of Philadelphia. Now a chance on home ice. Rangers, Flyers, next. The network that takes you to Rangers country welcomes you live to the world's most famous arena. Eric Lindros and the Philadelphia Flyers are in town to take on the New York Rangers. Good evening, everybody. I'm Al Troutwick. Welcome to another night of hockey here on MSG. Knicks and Miami Heat currently getting ready to go on MSG2. As for tonight's game, Sam and JD, yet another chance for this Ranger team to show that they can play the physical style of Philadelphia.
Exactly right, Al, and that's something you have to look forward to when the Flyers come to town. The one thing to remember is that the Rangers have faced every type of game on home ice and done well.
Compared to 1 year ago, the Rangers are a better team defensively, and that includes the six defensemen they put on the ice. And they're a better team depth-wise, especially with size up front and scoring up front. So they should be able to compete, and they've already beaten the Flyers twice in Philadelphia. But always be respectful of the Flyers. This is a club that's big. It's had a lot of scoring chances. It's had trouble scoring, but it's a tough team.
Last home game for the Rangers before they start a road trip. This is what's ahead as they come into tonight's game unbeaten in 21 straight here at the Garden. Then they'll go on the road for four straight games.
Well, four games in 11 days. That's a nice schedule to relax, practice, try to stay as healthy as possible. Colin Campbell talked about home ice and the streak they're on, 17-0-4 in the last 21 games. He says it's nice to be confident. It's nice to be a little bit cocky. But remember that word respectful. Be respectful of your opponent and have yourself ready.
I don't know how respectful the Rangers have been of the Flyers in Philadelphia in those first two games. They really let the Flyers have it a little bit.
The first one was a fairly tight game. The second game, the Rangers were by far the dominant club. They took care of Eric Lindros and his line. They played him tough. They stuck together as a team. They didn't back down when the big guy played an aggressive game. This is Karpovtsev moving in. Bang. He was paired with Ulf Samuelsson. They did a good job. And when their big line doesn't score, it creates a major problem for the Flyers because they don't have much scoring once the big line is shut down. They got scoring from unlikely heroes such as Langdon and Bookaboom in the two games. So it's really been good for the Rangers winning in Philadelphia. Now they have a chance to win the season series here at home tonight.
Now with the Philadelphia Flyers, this is a team that is really strange. They've only won one of their last six. They've only lost one of their last six. They've had four ties. In fact, they've had five ties in their last eight games.
Not scoring. That's the main reason. They say they're getting a lot of scoring chances, but when you take away the big line, and Renberg, by the way, is injured for this game, and they have combined for 76 of their 159, then you look at the rest of the forwards and you go, what's going on here? Well, Otto's been demoted to the third line. Brindamore is now going to play left wing, and they've made a deal to get Danny Quinn here from Ottawa for future considerations. DeMaio will go in on the big line with Eric Lindros. He's not big, but he plays a gutsy, courageous game, and he'll stir it up out there. And with Quinn, they're hoping somehow to get offense. He's played for eight different teams. He had one season in Pittsburgh, had 40 goals, so he knows how to score. And they're just begging for scoring from somebody away from the Lindros line.
What was interesting is with DeMaio out, Coach Terry Murray said, we really missed Rob DeMaio's presence. Here's a guy that's only 5'10", 190 pounds at most, and they felt that they really missed him the most.
Check the size of his heart. Check how much courage he plays with. And this is, some teams can be flat without that type of player. The Flyers have been flat without DeMaio.
Well, we'll see if they stay flat with DeMaio back. The Rangers hope they do. Rangers and Flyers, game number three of the season series. Next. The Rangers are 29-11-8, 66 points. first in the Eastern Conference, Ron Hextall starting in goal. It's the fifth consecutive game that he's started, 15-6-4 on the season.
When the Rangers were last in Philadelphia, the Rangers shut the Flyers out, and in warm-up, Le Perrier of the Rangers and Hextall did have a few words. Ron's a very superstitious individual. There he tried to put his skate over center ice. He didn't quite get it done, and then here they are again in warm-up. And what Ron gets upset with is when one of the players goes over center ice. Now here, Le Perrier tried to get to him, but Hextall kept his cool, yeah, kept his focus, and that's good to see for him. Glenn Healy, who's undefeated in his last six games, gets the start for the Rangers.
Rangers are 4-0-2 overall. In their last six, Glenn Healy making his eighth consecutive start. The Rangers open up with Sergei Nemchinov centering for Nicklas Sundstrom and Pat Verbeek, with Alexander Karpovtsev and Ulf Samuelsson on defense. Flyers, Peter Svoboda, number 24. Carl Dykhouse, number 24. Svoboda, 23. The giveaway, Verbeek's shot is blocked by Dykhouse. Dykhouse with the puck for Sean Podine, number 25, who's on with Joel Otto, number 29, and Trent Klatt, number 20.
Mentioned right off the top, Sam, that this game is going back into Russia. There's some Russian broadcasters here, and I'd like to see how the Ranger Russian players, Karpovtsev, Nemchinov, who had a real good first shift, and Kovalov, let's see how they play.
DeMaio's first shift, and he comes out with a good hit on Karpovtsev. Le Perrier hits the back of the net. Samuelsson sends it up the boards. Danny Lacroix in the lineup for the Rangers tonight with Langdon and Le Perrier. Here's Rod DeMaio, number 9, who's on with Eric Lindros, number 88, and John LeClair, number 10.
Boy, Le Perrier
is out with a stomach injury.
Oh, boy, this is a banger to start with. Le Perrier, Lindros, wow. And then DeMaio tripped up Le Perrier. And Jackson, the referee, letting it all go.
And he didn't see the trip on Le Perrier in center. Now he's got a penalty coming up.
Flyers have one coming up, but baby, the joint here already's got some feeling of electricity, doesn't it? Talking about the guard, there's something about the Flyers when they're here in New York. It's a little bit of liveliness, and then when you get 22 white involved now in a game, watch out.
When Le Perrier's on the ice, something's going to happen, and here it goes.
Le Perrier with Lindros, he'll move across with him and take him out right there with a push shove, and then Eric will trip up Le Perrier there. Then there was another trip.
DeMaio
right there on Le Perrier taking a dive, Sam. I think there was a cross check, but he certainly helped and went down easily. Finally, the call was made, and the Rangers have the first power play as LeClair there upends Darren Langdon. So it's power play time. Hextall's at the bench having a skate repaired. That's why we have a slight delay.
And give the Rangers fourth line credit.
Absolutely.
For drawing a penalty.
I noticed, too, that Messier didn't start right away. He was skating around during the stoppage, checking out, I think, one of his skates. Kevin Lowe not in the lineup.
Kevin Lowe, a late scratch. He had a sore heel this morning as he came off from practice. So it means the return of Mattias Norrström. A couple of weeks early, he was injured December 30th in Edmonton, suffered a shoulder separation.
That's a combination of a good training staff, good doctors, the hyperbaric chamber, and the patient really keying in to work hard to try and quicken the recovery. And everybody worked together strongly to get Mattias back into the lineup early.
LeClair for holding at 113. Rangers tied for fifth in the NHL on the power play. The Flyers are second in the league in penalty killing, first in the league on the road. The penalty killing has been outstanding. Driver and Leach with Messier, Verbeek, and Graves. Sorry, John.
Rangers tied for fifth, you mentioned, on the power play, tied with the Flyers.
Mm-hmm. Rangers have scored 56 power play goals. Messier playing it across. Rod Brind'Amour, who has a couple of three shorthanded goals, is on the ice with Trent Klatt, Eric Desjardins, number 37, and Kevin Holler, number 5. Verbeek in deep. He has 14 power play goals. Leaves it for Messier. Now Leach with room. The shot. Save Hextall. The rebound played by Brind'Amour. And he slides it down.
The Flyers, when the Rangers beat them in Philadelphia, the shutout, the Flyers did not have Svoboda or Holler in the lineup. And they're thin on the blue line without two key players like that. They're both back in the game for this one, healthy. And I think it should add to their team.
Good pressure by Ferraro on Kjell Samuelsson, forced a turnover. Now Samuelsson hit his old man McTavish, but it came out of the zone. McTavish on with Podine, Svoboda, and Kjell Samuelsson. Karpovtsev with the puck. 28 seconds to go on the Rangers power play.
Ferraro chases it down. Ferraro on with Kovalov and Robitaille. Leach and Karpovtsev. Leach moves around Fodin. Fires into the corner. Robitaille takes it. Checked there by Svoboda. Kovalov hit by Kjell Samuelsson. Ferraro. Save Hextall. Ferraro's rebound. Another save. Kovalov trying to bank it in. It was cleared aside by Samuelsson. Team's back at full strength. Shot by Karpovtsev. Blocked by Svoboda. Outlet for Lindros. Went by him. Healy covers up.
All right, there's a bounce to the puck, or it would have been a breakaway. Hextall with some pretty good goaltending as the Rangers jammed the net. That's Leach on the puck on the power play. When he's the quarterback, things happen. Watch how smart he is getting the puck into the zone, dumping it to the corner away from four Flyers to allow the Rangers to get the puck, which led to offense. The only time the Rangers got offense on that power play, and it was twice, is because Leach got the puck into the zone through the neutral zone.
Off the faceoff in the Rangers zone, Dan Quinn on for the first time in his second tour of duty with the Flyers.
1991-92, he played with the club.
1 year under Bill Dineen. Rangers with five shots on goal, four on that last power play. It's Dan Quinn, number 11, with Rod Brind'Amour, number 17, and Pat Falloon, number 15. Quinn in the corner against Driver. Centering pass missed by Falloon, comes out to Desjardins. He's hit by Graves. Brind'Amour with a back pass, shot by Holler, is knocked down, cleared out by Verbeek. Holler gets back for it, gave it away to Messier. Messier moves across. Tries to slide it to Graves. He turns, he shoots, glove saved by Hextall.
Good play there where the Rangers stayed onside. Verbeek lost the puck. Messier, I believe, got it, and Verbeek just slammed the brakes down. I mean, he just really stopped at the blue line, which allowed the Rangers to continue. Look at Leach right there. Verbeek stopped. See? Now Messier moves in, and you'll see, look at this pass. Traps two right. Flyers to Graves, and then a good wrist shot. Hextall looks sharp. 6-1 the shots. Hextall looks real sharp. What do you call those anti-lock brakes, I guess, Verbeek's
name? That's good.
All I know is I go through a lot of brakes.
McTavish and Ferraro for the face-off. Ferraro wins. Bukaboom shoots. And it went through Hextall, but wide of the net. Puck cleared out. And played by Ferraro. Chris Therrien, number 6. Able to move it out. Kovalov takes over. Russ Romanek, number 42, with Craig McTavish, number 14, and Anatoly Semenov, number 44, for Philadelphia. Flyers coming off a 1-1 tie Monday night in Philadelphia. They came on late to score the goal to tie Florida.
Well, here's the 1-2-2 forecheck by the Flyers. They're back out. Now, basically, they're playing the trap. Now they'll try and swarm Leach. He does a nice job getting the puck deep. Now you have to recover it.
Samuelsson plays it up the boards. Flyers come out with it. Semenov. Leach is there. Semenov slides it deep. Healy out to stop it. Fires back up the boards. Rangers come out. Kovalov. Ferraro to the right. Robitaille trailing. Ferraro looking. Deflects on the way in. Hextall with a good play. Came out quickly to clear the puck. Yeah. Karpovtsev takes over.
He looks sharper and better here than he did in Philadelphia.
Yeah.
Talking about Ron Hextall. I mean, he's real sharp right now.
Rangers
up to the
changing.
Rangers to get his focus out of focus.
Samuelsson to Nemchinov. Now Karpovtsev, Nemchinov on with Sundstrom and Presley. Well, Samuelsson brings it out. Lead for Presley. Presley moves in, his shot blocked by Kevin Holler. Nemchinov missed the bouncing puck. Joel Otto's got it for Philadelphia. Drives it wide of the net. Trent Platt missed it. Podin, centering pass, blocked by Otto. Otto takes it deep. Checked by Matthias Nordstrom. And a penalty on Nordstrom.
Cross-checking will be the call. The Flyers, who've been outshot 7-1 to this point, will have their first power play to deal with. Nordstrom back from the shoulder injury. And he gets a penalty early. You see here, he'll be working. It's a 2-on-2 on the boards here. Otto gets the position a little bit. There's a shove, and then there's another shove. And I guess more Otto off balance and Nordstrom's strength shoving Otto down. Now, you'll see here the puck goes towards the goal. Two Rangers go to the net, but it's a sharp Hextall. Look at, bang, he goes right out. You can see ahead of the two Ranger forwards and move the puck out of the zone. A good instinctive move by Hextall, who so far, we're 7 minutes in, or nearly 7 minutes, showing that he's sharp, real sharp.
6 minutes in on seven.
Excuse me.
Not bad. We're close.
Oh, yeah.
Only a minute off.
That's all.
Graves takes the puck out. Flyers power play tied for fifth in the league. They've scored 50 power play goals. Three players have 29 of the 50. And those three players are Lindros, Renberg, and LeClaire. And, of course, as we mentioned, Renberg out tonight.
LeClaire with 10. Lindros and Renberg with 9 apiece.
Oh, and they score here. It's tipped in beautifully on a beautiful feed. Pat Falloon scores, and the Flyers take a 1-0 lead.
That's the type of goal that Falloon will score. One where he has to just go to the net without the puck. Somebody moves it to him, and it's a tap-in. Not often will you see him drive through traffic with a puck. NMCS Cannon goal cam, look at it. Watch the puck get deep here. Rangers appeared to have it, but there's some good second effort, then a great pass across. Falloon goes to the net. He's smart without the puck getting to the net, and he'll be there for those tap-in type goals. He won't go through six players and make a play. Hit along the boards on Brindamore and then Quinn. You saw him look. Falloon was going to the net, and a nice, nice pass, and it's a nice power play goal.
So Pat Quinn in his first game as a Philadelphia Flyer contributes offensively. That's what they got him for, to produce offense, a good passer, a good goal scorer. Comes up with an assist on the goal by Pat Falloon. Rod Brindamore, I believe, will also get an assist on the goal. 6:26 is the time. And the Flyers have a 1-0 lead. Rangers, Flyers are offside coming across.
As a goaltender in a perfect world, when you think about goals that are scored against you, you try to figure out what you could have done differently. And on that goal, I wonder if Glenn Healy's thinking that perhaps with Quinn making the pass, he could have used his goal stick. I don't know if the puck was close enough to his body or not. Let's watch again. Where does the puck go? Does it go through the crease? Yeah, it does. I think basically Glenn was thinking shot instead of a pass, but on that play in a perfect world, he would have wanted to have used his goal stick to deflect the puck away from Falloon.
Langdon got hit, and the whistle stops play. Langdon shaken up.
I think right here, right now, you're right, Langdon heading off. He must be shaking a little bit. Rangers want to come back here now. We'll see the hit on him.
Oh, the puck went up into his face.
Caught him in the face, yeah. I think what the Rangers want here after giving up the goal is for their fourth line to get on the ice and really stir it up, create something, maybe draw another power play. Right up high, quick, goes the puck, and right off the left cheekbone, it looked like. Darren is still at the bench, checking his jaw out. See if he's able to do anything. He's turning his head, trying to figure it out with trainer Jim Ramsey. So the Rangers now make a change. It's Messier against McTavish.
SEA controls, Bukaboom slides it in. Therrien there to play it. 13 minutes to go in the first. Flyers a 1-0 lead. The goal was Balloon's 11th from Quinn.
Flyers changing on the fly here. They want the Lindros line on the ice against the Messier unit. These two coaches love to match. This division, coaching-wise, they match lines more than any other division in the NHL.
Therrien brings it across, offside Philadelphia.
Well, the Rangers are lucky. They had three defensemen on the ice for quite a while there.
12:39 to go in the first. Flyers have a 1-0 lead. We'll be right back. Remember, when you're having good times with good friends, drink responsibly, because friends know when to say when. A reminder from your friends at Budweiser.
In this type of game, it's very important for the referee to try to keep the flow, but both these coaches are really looking at who the other team has on the ice and trying to get the appropriate matchups.
Quality chances early. Rangers have had four, and Ron Hextall has been sharp early. Messier line on. Dan Quinn moving the puck. Kevin Haller is there. Up ahead for Pat Falloon. Desjardins to his right. Falloon moves in on Leach and shoots. Save made by Healy with a blocker. Puts it up into the crowd.
Pretty good sneaky wrist shot there that Glenn got a piece of. Take a look at the man who took the wrist shot, talking about Falloon. Again, the Flyers really trying to find a way to get a second line that can score. Joel Otto's been moved to the third line. There's the wrist shot using the defenseman Brian Leach as a screen. Look at Falloon look to his right and shoot it to his left. That's trying to make the goaltender think that there's going to be a pass here and not a shot. And Healy got a piece of the puck as it went by, and that was a tricky play.
Flyers controlling. Rod Brindamore, you know, you talk about scoring, John. Brindamore has provided scoring, but they need more of it from other people. Brind'Amour has 53 points this season. There's a lead for Messier. The pass in escapes and offside is whistled.
Adam Graves taking a penalty. It's a holding call. It was behind the play, and it looked like the pass actually went into Messier's skate. If it was on a stick blade, he was gone for the breakaway. But as that was happening, in behind the play, Adam Graves took the penalty. Over on the right side, Adam Graves will get tied up with his man right here. That's Haller. He stays with Haller, and he stays with Haller, and he stays with Haller, and he's still with Haller. And he's still with him. And as the play heads up ice, he was still with him. And Haller's the right defenseman. He couldn't get back in the play, so Jackson made the call.
That started earlier, John, yeah. Early in the first period in the Rangers offensive zone.
How about last year? Remember Haller and Messier?
Sure.
They've had a running battle for a long period of time.
Graves for holding at 8:01. Flyers are 1-for-1 on the power play. They have Lindros, LeClaire, and DeMaio with Dykhouse and Therrien. Dykhouse goes off now, and Svoboda comes on.
DeMaio must think he died and went to heaven. Fourth line player, next thing you know, he's on the power play.
Lindros' shot is a save by Healy.
Good work away from the goaltender by the two defensemen taking Flyers out when big Eric Lindros took the wrist shot. No rebound, but if there was one, both men were covered. I mean, DeMaio's on the Lindros line on the power play. This is wonderful for him. Look at the shot here. Actually, there was a Flyer open for a moment. That was DeMaio, as Vukaboom actually gets picked right there by DeMaio. Now DeMaio goes to the net, does have room. If Lindros saw that, he may have moved the puck over to DeMaio. Good save by Healy and a good play by Leach, taking LeClaire out of the play.
Lindros against Messier, puck back to Desjardins. Now DeMaio winds up and shoots wide. Puck around the board, Svoboda to Desjardins. Turns for the long shot, save Healy. Messier can't clear, shot DeMaio is blocked. DeMaio again, blocked. And it's cleared by Sundstrom.
Flyers, this is a power play, folks, that isn't fancy. Anybody in a shooting position has shot the puck.
Here comes Rob DeMaio, who started his NHL career with the Islanders, went to Tampa Bay before coming to Philadelphia. DeMaio back to Svoboda. Now DeMaio with some room. Wrist shot deflects over the top. 1 minute to go on the power play for the Flyers. Now to Desjardins. Now Lindros. Checked by Driver. Driver and Samuelson on with Messier and Presley. Shot by Lindros. Hit Driver. Cameron's behind the net. LeClaire wraparound. Stopped by Healy. And Driver is there to help out. Pushing and shoving. Oh, it gets rough now.
You got to get tough in front of your own goal. The Flyers are playing a very determined game here. Samuelson and Lindros, Messier and DeMaio. DeMaio does this. He's good at it. You've got to battle in your own zone. And here the Rangers are. The Flyers still have 42 seconds to go on the Adam Graves penalty. This is heating up. This is a very determined game. Both teams going at it. Lindros on the puck. And this shot gets blocked by Driver. Down he goes. And watch the close play here with LeClaire on the puck. He tries the wraparound. DeMaio got flattened. But Healy did a good job stopping the wraparound by LeClaire, and then everybody got into it. Heated game.
Boy, was that rough out in front.
This is what we're going to see a lot of in the last portion of this season. The Rangers have a lot of intra-divisional games.
And this is an important game for the Flyers. They have not played well in divisional games thus far this season. They're 5-8-3. And in 0-3-1 in their last four division games, and of course two losses to the Rangers. Out to Carl Dykhouse. Checked there by Sundstrom. Bounces past Quinn. Balloon after it. Now Quinn coming out in front, flitter right through. Shot by Balloon, and I believe Healy got a piece of it. Around the board, set up for Balloon, just shot it wide. And
Quinn with another nice pass there.
Puck around to Quinn. Checked by Leach. Brind'Amour to Quinn, comes through to Dykhouse, his shot went wide. Therrien after the puck. He hits Vukaboom. Balloon takes over. He's shot. It's blocked by Healy and he holds it. He's all Flyers.
He's firing the puck at the net. Well, they're on the power play and their power play's good. And they still have 8 seconds to go. They've got DeMaio, the Flyers do, and Quinn. They both woke up and think they arrived at heaven on ice. I mean, Quinn was with Ottawa, struggling, not playing. Chateau, Bow Wow, the whole thing. Next thing you know, he's on this team. Fifth-ranked power play in a team that's a good club. There's a good body check there. This is Falloon again. He takes the shot from the angle. This is what the Flyers are doing, Sam, on their power play. No matter who's got the puck, they're just blasting it. They missed the net quite a bit here, but they're just going right at the net. One important faceoff left on the power play now.
McTavish on against Messier. 8 seconds to go on the man advantage.
Flyers have attempted 9 shots in this power play. 5 have connected with Glenn Healy.
Messier plays it across. Sundstrom goes for it. Graves set to return. Leach comes out of the corner with a puck. Graves is back on. Teams at full strength. 3-on-2 Rangers. Graves, Messier. Shot saved by Hextall. And the net's off the pegs.
Big rebound there that got away from Ronnie. Big rebound in front, but everybody in the Rangers went by the net and missed the rebound as the Rangers moved up ice on a quick, good rush. Graves out of the penalty box. Now, as he gives the puck to Messier, everybody goes to that. Look where the rebound goes. Somehow that one got away from Hextall, and he got away with it as everybody went by the puck. Leach with the rush. Messier wants the puck and gets it. The two wingers drive to the net, but look where the puck goes. I don't know how that got away from Hextall, but it did.
Ron Hextall, who is second in the NHL in goals against average at 2.18. Chris Osgood of Detroit leads at 2.17. And Ron Hextall is third in the league in save percentage at .918. Some very, very good numbers. Giveaway, Robitaille couldn't control. Takes down McTavish. Out comes Joel Otto. Down the boards comes Sean Codine. Shot by Otto. And a penalty's coming up. Should be on Joel Otto. The shot was by Shel Samuelson. Got through.
It will be for contact with the goaltender, Glenn Healy. Made a good save, by the way. He tightened everything up. Legs, arms, all together. The puck got through, and as the puck hit him, so did big Joel Otto. So he goes to the penalty box. The Rangers need a change. They need a flow here. A flow change to get some offense. It's interference with the goaltender. There you see the bump. And Joel Otto was not pushed into Glenn Healy. He went in on his own as he turned. Now watch Otto in front. There he turns. He's by himself, and he turns again, and bang, right into Healy. And he's responsible for that, and the call's made.
Otto called for interference with the goaltender. Here's the play again.
Good save by Healy as the puck went right through the big body of Joel Otto. So the Rangers, who had 4 shots, was it, on their power play,
yep,
Sam, and didn't score, now have a chance to try to tie the game up in 1. They trail 1-0. Shots are dead even at 9 apiece.
10:31, the time of the penalty to Joel Otto. Ferraro comes on with Verbeek and Robitaille, Leach and Driver for the power play. Brindamore with Codine, Svoboda, and Desjardins for Philadelphia.
Flyers just changed Haller, got him off the ice. They want him on the ice as much as they can against Mark Messier.
Ferraro looking for the puck, so is Robitaille. Now Verbeek trying to move it. Stopped by Desjardins. Robitaille and Svoboda. Svoboda moves it. Driver gets it across to Leach. Back to Driver. Now Leach. Driver looks and shoots. Save Hextall. Verbeek trying to get it to Ferraro. Desjardins is there. Ferraro gets it to Robitaille. Out to Driver. Tip by Brindamore, who's on now. Ferraro, pass deflected, knocked down by Driver. Leaves it for Leach. Brindamore is there. Around to Ferraro. Hit by Svoboda. Ferraro stays with it, gives it to Leach. Down the boards for Verbeek. Passed him to Robitaille.
Flyers keeping the puck to the outside here nicely. Very aggressive. Penalty kill.
Codine, stopped by Driver. Good play toward the net. Intercepted by Desjardins, and he clears.
You see why Brindamore is one of the best penalty killers in the league. Very smart at trying to take away the passing lane when Brian Leach in particular had the puck.
Leach on the move. 35 seconds to go on the Rangers power play. Messier for Kovalov. Just wide. Messier for Karpovtsev, and he shot it wide.
Hextall did not see that one.
Leach moves it down to Graves. On to Messier, tipped by Haller. Haller moves away. Gets out of the zone with the puck. Haller with a nice move. Slow down by Kovalov. Karpovtsev brings it back. Lost control. Healy's got to play it. Swings it to Kovalov. Now to Leach. 5 seconds in the power play. Messier racing down the right side. Leach to Messier. The trailer. Kovalov off his stick out of the zone.
Joel Otto didn't have his stick ready when he came out of the penalty box.
This will be an icing on the Flyers. There's a whistle behind the play, and we've got penalties coming up. one to each team. Kovalov and Otto. We'll be right back.
Kovalov has 11 goals on the season. This is one reason why it's only 11. Right there with the puck, and he missed the net from a great scoring opportunity, great position to score from. And then Karpovtsev, he too missed the net on that one. Hextall didn't see the shot as he was screened. Both those chances were on the power play. Now we have 4-on-4 action with Joel Otto and Alexei Kovalov in the penalty box.
2 minutes each for roughing at 11:10. Flyers a 1-0 lead on a power play goal by Pat Falloon. Lindros, LeClaire, Desjardins, three all-stars, and Kevin Holler. For Philadelphia, Samuelson and
that's
Karpovtsev.
A crazy hit by Karpovtsev. This is something that...
Yeah, penalty coming up.
No, he just went right into... I thought it was LeClaire, hit him way up in the face and takes a minor, and this puts the Rangers down a man. 4-on-4 action. You love to play hard, but you're trailing 1-0.
Play smart.
Absolutely. Against a power play that's been scary so far, and talking about the Flyers' power play, and Potsy Karpovtsev took the penalty. Now here's Lindros just at the whistle as he and Samuelson have been going at one another, and we'll see that every game these two teams play against one another if they're in the lineup.
So the Flyers get their third power play. Karpovtsev for high sticking at 12:50. And it's a 4-on-3 power play advantage. Checking something thrown on the ice. One of the linesmen able to pick it up, clear it off. Lindros, LeClaire, Brindamore, and Desjardins for the power play. Messier, Graves, and Leach, the Rangers' penalty killing unit. Lindros leads the Flyers with 27 goals. Brindamore feeding it to LeClaire, checked by Leach. Brindamore, who leads the team with 40 assists. Lindros. Desjardins, checked by Messier. Brindamore for Desjardins, now Lindros. LeClaire is set up top of the crease. The pass tipped by Leach. Brindamore. Now Desjardins. Down low. Brindamore to Lindros. Shot it wide. Brilliant feed. Great passing by the Flyers to set up Lindros, but he missed the net. And at 15 to go on the power play. Healy plays it up the boards. Samuelson looking for it. Samuelson on now with Graves and Messier battling Lindros. Here's LeClaire with a puck. Samuelson hits him. Messier takes the puck, and it's knocked down by Brindamore. Graves hustles and clears. That was good effort by Samuelson, Graves, and Messier. Back come the Flyers. Brindamore to the puck. Turns and finds Lindros. Saved by Healy.
Now Eric was shut right down in Philadelphia in the two games with the Rangers. Here he's finding opportunities to at least shoot the puck. He's already missed the net on this power play with a good opportunity. This time he does hit the net. Hextall alertly moved the puck up ice as the Rangers were changing. They did recover, and a good effort there by Brindamore, who's having a strong period. And there's the quick shot by Lindros. And again, Glenn Healy plays the angle very well. Brindamore beats Healy to the puck there. And look at the nice pass. The thing that saved the Rangers there was the goaltender had a chance to move across because Lindros had to go from his backhand to the forehand. Here's some battle. Lindros along with Samuelson. That's battle. Man alive, you do that for pure hockey game, and that's a tiring way to have to battle.
Here it is from the MCS Cannon goal cam.
Sticks down. Good battle. LeClaire, he's so quick in the corners. He can turn quickly. And Brindamore here. Brindamore knocks the puck right out of midair. That was a nice play to keep the play alive. And then good hustle by Graves. This is like a playoff period,
yeah,
with the efforts the two teams are playing with.
Quinn won the faceoff. Dykhouse is set up, but he shanked the shot. Leach steps in. Leach and Bukaboom on now with Sundstrom. So it's two defensemen now and one forward for the Rangers, and Leach clears.
We've had more body contact in the first 15 minutes here than we saw in the entire game Monday night in Los Angeles.
Dykhouse leads Quinn. Leach stops him. Pass across for Lindros. Off his stick. He turns. Plays it into the corner. Lindros, DeMaio, Quinn, and Dykhouse for Philadelphia. DeMaio in the corner. Leach trying to take it away. Kukubuma and Lindros go for it. Kovalov and Otto are back. It's 5-on-4. Messier with a block and a clear. And that's going to do it. Here comes Karpovtsev. Teams are at full strength.
Well, the fans appreciate that. Flyers are now what? One for three. In the first. Oh!
Steal. Score. No, post. Ferraro, a wide open net.
Baby.
A wide open net. He hit the post.
Ferraro stole a puck. He faked the shot. Hextall was swimming. Ferraro missed.
We are back just off the faceoff. Flyers move it down the ice. Ray Ferraro hit the post. Had a wide open net. And he hit the post. 4:40 to go in the first as the crowd is alive. Kovalov moves in. Steps around flat. And his shot deflected by Therrien into the crowd.
Oh, that's... Now, see, though, there's a play. You like to see a tough game. Kovalov took the shot. It was deflected into the stands. They're standing right in front of the referee. Therrien, a big tough defensive, put his hand right into Kovalov's face. No penalty. A good play here by Ferraro and faking the shot as his old teammate in junior hockey, Ronnie Hextall, moves out. He took his time and just got too fine. Didn't quite finish. There's the reaction.
And his teammate on the Islanders, too.
Yeah, right. Yeah, I forgot about that one. My goodness, was that some play.
Big chance. 4:32 to go in the first. Flyers leading 1-0. And Ferraro talking it over with Wayne Pressly, still in disbelief.
To mention while we have a second here that I heard good news out of Florida today for the Panther fans.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like they're staying in South Florida. Now here's the last play of the Rangers head up ice. Kovalov, I believe, will take the puck all the way up ice, take the shot. Now watch six. The left defenseman there, move across, does a nice job blocking the shot there. Then he moved into Kovalov, and standing there, gave him a pretty good facial.
There it is.
Look at the referee. The referee's yelling at Therrien, saying, what are you doing? Last time I checked, when you do things like that after a whistle, it's supposed to be a penalty.
Let him play, boys.
Oh, let him play. Boy, have we converted you. Drop the gloves, everybody.
No. Kovalov against McTavish.
You wouldn't want to see a penalty called for that. I apologize.
Driver moves it down. Therrien hits Kovalov. They battle. That time he pulled Kovalov down. Nothing called. Shel Samuelson's got the puck. Frank McTavish. Try to get it to Podine. And a whistle for an offside on the Flyers.
I understand that South Florida story. The commissioners in the Broward County Sunrise area will be voting, I think, tomorrow. And I hear the vote is going to be that they will spend up to 75% of what it takes to build a new arena. They're hoping Wayne Azinga, the owner of the team now, will build and throw in the other 25% to build the arena. They're hoping he'll keep the team. I don't know if he will, but the word out of there, and was on the radio down there all day today, it looks like there's a strong chance they're staying in South Florida. That's terrific news.
Yeah.
They built a good club there. There's a good loyal following. They need a new arena, and will probably, you know, take 2 or 3 years for that to happen, but good news to this point.
It would be an utter shame, John, with a team coming on the way it has, for that team to pick up and move now.
You're not kidding.
Verbeek has to play it across as LaFerriere had to get onside. Semenov picks up the puck off the boards.
Offside.
Russ Romanek, but in the zone was Craig McTavish, offside Philadelphia. John, what are your thoughts about Jacques Martin, new coach up in Ottawa?
It's interesting. I'd like to know, I haven't been able to figure it out yet, exactly what Colorado said. If they just, Jacques Martin was an assistant coach with the Colorado Hockey Club, and he leaves them to go to Ottawa in midstream. I think, if the Rockies just let him go to further his own position, that's terrific. And I think he'll do a good job in Ottawa.
The Avalanche, pardon me.
I think he'll do a good job in Ottawa. It certainly looks like, you hate to see people lose their jobs, obviously, but it looks like the new general manager, Pierre Gauthier, in Ottawa, he's revamping everything in a hurry. He's starting over, and they want to climb up. And he deserves credit for that.
Leach with a steal. Moving in. Backhander stopped by Hextall. Bounces loose to Leach. His shot, he scores! Brian Leach stayed with it all the way.
Why did he ever?
Dan, the puck went underneath the crossbar, knocked the water bottle way off the top of the net. What a shot. Hextall was down, hoping for a low shot. It didn't. It went right over his shoulder. The Rangers are working now. They've had a good run here for 2 or 3 minutes. Flyers look to be in good shape. Good forecheck and a giveaway right there. Look at Leach. His original shot, he's dancing with the puck. It's stopped. Now watch Leach get the puck. And look at Hextall still down hoping. Oh, baby.
Wow.
What a shot. Leach is dancing in this first period with the puck. That shot was on goal. Leach got to the rebound and just snapped it up over the shoulder. And we're tied at one.
Brian Leach leads all. And another steal by Kovalov. Here's Robitaille. And it carried wide. Robitaille fires and it's intercepted by Desjardins. Flyers move across. 4-on-2. Center back for Brindamore, and his shot went wide. Now here comes Ray Ferraro. Quinn catches up. Desjardins has it back. A whistle for an offside.
Delayed
offside. Flyers have it back. Quinn's got the puck. Leach from Messier and Graves to tie it 1-1 at 16:33. Leach leads all defensemen in the NHL in scoring with 53 points. He now has points in 7 straight games. And in 11 of his last 12. And the fans with the Hextall chant.
I don't know how this game's going to turn out, but that penalty kill by the Rangers with Karpinsev in the box.
Nemchinov went wide.
I just think that penalty kill was so important, it gave the Rangers some life.
Good play by Karpinsev. Moves across and shoots, deflected, and a save by Hextall. Turned out to be a tricky shot on the deflection. Here comes Lindros. Karpinsev getting back. Lindros hit by Karpinsev, stays with the puck, fires across. LeClaire is stopped.
Oh,
saved by Healy.
How about that? Lindros is so strong, so fast. The two Rangers ran into each other. That opened up the ice, and then Glenn Healy, he attacked. Flat out attacked this man. LeClaire made the save. Clear Karpinsev chase here. Now what's Karpinsev in? Bang! There's a collision with Presley that opens the ice up. And look at that. Healy attacked with his stick, got his catching glove up, made some kind of save off the all-star John LeClaire. Lindros with a great play. LeClaire with a great play. And Healy with a great play. Look at his strength. Boom! Karpinsev taken out by his own man in this game now. We've got hitting early. We've had some good goaltending. Now we have a lot of pace to it. This is fun to watch.
Rangers 14 shots, Flyers 12. 1-1 the score. Desjardins backhander. Save Healy. The rebound carries to the corner. LaFerriere able to move it ahead. It's out of the zone.
Penalty
on the Flyers.
Lacroix knocked down by Svoboda.
And it may have been Codine, John. Even Sean Codine.
I'm wondering if there's a second penalty because there's another Ranger down. I don't know if this was a legitimate stick player. If LaFerriere took a dive, he's now up. But there could be more than one penalty. Terry Murray never says much on the bench, but he bubbles at times. 1:43 to go in the first period. We're tied up at one. Just look at his intensity. I'm telling you, this is one fired up hockey game. Now we have, you're right, I think it is Codine going to the box. Yes, you're right. He right here pulls the stick and then kicks the feet out of Lacroix away from the puck. So the Rangers in a 1-1 game have a power play to finish the period. There you see the stick, Codine pulling down Lacroix.
Danny Lacroix hasn't played much, but he plays against the Flyers.
And it was Svoboda who put the stick into the midsection groin area of LaFerriere. You're right, he does. And he seems to play well against them.
Codine for tripping at 18-17, third power play for the Rangers. They're 0 for 2. Game tied 1-1. Leach and Falloon, the goal scorers. Messier, Verbeek, and Graves. Driver and Leach for the power play. Otto, DeMaio, Desjardins, and Haller, the penalty killing unit for the Flyers. Driver fires in. Hextall fires out. And it's 25 to go in the first period. Driver moves in again. Verbeek shoots. Stick to side. Leach. Driver's open. Fakes. finds Graves, and his pass was blocked. Loose puck, and it's blocked again. Verbeek looking for it, stopped by Desjardins. Messier looking for it, Verbeek and Desjardins are down. Loose puck, Hextall and Messier go forth. The referee lost sight of it and blew the whistle. As we've got some wrestling going on.
Desjardins is down underneath Adam Graves, I believe, as everybody really battles hard for the loose pucks here. Hextall did fire the puck down the ice, Sam, and then Healy went and got it, just fired it right back at Hextall. Ronnie, he loves to talk. Eddie Belfour during the All-Star game, I talked to all six goalies. Who they thought were the best goalies in the league this year? Belfour picked Hextall. John Van Beesbrecht picked Mike Richter.
No, not
six
bad.
Different goalies. I asked all six a question.
And they all had,
and
different,
all had
answers.
Different answers. Every single one of them.
You know those goalies.
Yeah, you're right. You're absolutely right. A bunch of wackos.
They're out there.
Now, the whistle sounded already. And Hextall. Yeah, get rid of it. Healy went and got the puck and fired it back at Hextall.
Following the first period, Al's special guest will be Bruce Driver. Bob Page has an update at the sports desk. And JD and I will have highlights. Leach on the power play. Messier. All the way across the driver, toward the net, knocked away by Hextall. That may have pinged off the post.
That may have hit the goal post. I heard the sound. I may be wrong on that, but it appeared as though it did. What a pass by Messier across to this side of the ice through three different flyers. It was like a perfect, perfect pass out of reach from everybody. Let's try and listen whether it hit the post or not. Hit the outside of the goalpost. You can tell by the sound.
Hextall stops the puck. Knocked down by Driver. 40 seconds to go in the period. Svoboda was pulled down. McTavish is there. The puck is underneath and frozen for a faceoff.
The linesmen are having a busy game, aren't they? After every whistle, players are together and they need to be separated.
Svoboda back in the lineup. He missed the last meeting between these two teams.
Rangers now go with Luke Robitaille as opposed to Adam Graves for the last portion of this period. 37.3 seconds to go. And it's power play time for the Rangers.
Messier and Otto for the faceoff. Messier wins. Driver tees it up. Saved by Hextall. Verbeek. Looking, Messier, missed by Robitaille. Driver shoots, save Hextall. Two good saves by Ron Hextall. The puck knocked down by Driver, kept it in the zone. Messier's pass tipped out. Driver's got it. Leach with 10 seconds. Knocked away. Lindros breaking in.
He's got time.
Lindros to the net. Saved by Healy. Oh, that was a big one.
That was a one-handed shot, I think, by Eric Lindros. The fans stand and applaud. The goaltending is Glenn Healy. Lindros with a shorthanded try. Had time for the breakaway. Leach was there, but the strength of that guy showed how he could fight off a defender, and I think he gets a one-handed shot. Yeah, look at this. How about that? How about the save? Oh, baby. And a goal post away from it being a shorthanded goal. The strength of Eric Lindros. Look at this. The effort. Glenn Healy, and the puck sits calmly by the goalpost. Wow, what a period.
Each team scoring one. Falloon for the Flyers, Leach for the Rangers. Al with Bruce Driver in a moment. Sam Rosen, John Davidson, Al Trotwick back at Madison Square Garden. Let's look at first period highlights brought to you by Minolta, the official camera of the Garden. Flyers score first on the power play.
A couple of good plays here. You'll see Brindamore take the hit to make the pass. And then you'll see Danny Quinn fight to get loose. And a nice pass across to Falloon, who gets his 11th goal of the season.
Now, Rangers did some good penalty killing later on.
They had to when they trailed by one. And if you give the Flyers a two-goal lead, they're a pretty good club defensively. So the Rangers had a really battle. Samuelson with a good job. Here's Graves quickly to a loose puck. And he moved the puck out of the zone. Good Dykhouse with a bad pass there. Great play by Ferraro to go around Hextall, but hit the goalpost. It was still 1-0 at the time.
Here comes the Leach goal.
Well, what a play here. He's dancing with the puck. He's making quick moves. Here he goes after the rebound. Did he ever rifle the puck up top? All of a sudden, we're tied at one. And then Lindros, he's had a real strong period. So did Ben Healy, pardon me, as the Flyers had 13 shots. You see another one. That was a breakaway shorthanded by Eric Lindros. Healy was there again. Healy had a very strong period. A
lot of action in that first period. We'll see if it keeps up as we head for period number two. Don't go away. First period scoring summary is brought to you by Hertz. For business, for pleasure, nobody does it exactly like Hertz. Pat Falloon with his 11th on the power play from Dan Quinn. No assist to Rod Brindamore. We thought he should have gotten one. Leach is ninth from Messier and Graves at 16:33. Rangers 16 shots, Flyers 13. Lindros line with 6 shots, Eric Lindros with 3. Messier line with 4 shots on the power play. Flyers 1 for 3 with 7 shots on goal. Rangers 0 for 2. 16 seconds remaining in the penalty to Sean Podine as we start the second period. With the Rangers on the power play. Leach. Driver. Now Leach and Bukaboom come out with Messier, Graves, and Verbeek for the Rangers. Joel Otto, Chris Therrien, Shel Samuelson, and Trent Klatt for Philadelphia. And Samuelson clears all the way down. Flyers' next game will be Saturday afternoon at Pittsburgh. Rangers' next game Saturday afternoon at Boston.
Good luck in Boston.
Yeah, you too.
On Fox.
You'll be in,
I'll be in Pittsburgh.
Good games. Trent Klatt. Check there. Teams are back at full strength. Verbeek takes the puck away. Pat Verbeek with 33 goals, fourth in the NHL. Graves. Messier saved by Hextall. Nice play. Things opened up for the Rangers. Verbeek stopped by Shel Samuelson. Samuelson swings it around the boards for Sean Podine. Now it's Joel Otto. And Karpovtsev has it back. Kevin Lowe sitting out tonight's game. Scratch with a sore heel.
And Antoski, the big rugged forward for the Flyers, out with the flu.
Mm-hmm. Icing whistle against the Rangers. Joey Koser a scratch. Nick Kyprios a healthy scratch. Doug Lidster and Mike Richter both skated today hard. Mike Richter on his own took some shots after the full team practice. And Mike Richter is about 2 weeks away. Doug Lidster skated hard with the team.
Watch here and see how Messier got the puck. Two Flyers go over. One forgets about Messier. I believe that was Klatt. And Messier has a good low shot. Hextall made the save. Mark actually has a little more room here than I think he knew he had, or he may have moved in. Number 20, Trent Klatt, got caught not picking anybody up. Messier on the good dish from Graves had the shot.
Rangers away with the puck. Alexei Kovalov sends it in.
That's a good play. Kovalov jumped loose on the faceoff, got the puck, and then got it deep.
Driver stops it. His shot blocked. Craig McTavish picks it up. Flyers had 4 players in the All-Star game. Lindros, LeClaire, Desjardins, and Craig McTavish. Ferraro overskates. McTavish heads the other way. Looking. Passing in front for Semenov, who tipped it wide. Anatoly Semenov with the puck. Swings it around for Russ Romanek. He hit the back of the net and was checked by Matthias Nordstrom. Puck kept in by Dykhouse. Driver stops Semenov. McTavish claiming that he was being held, and he was.
Yeah, Driver held him up all the way across, away from the puck, so Jackson makes the call. This all goes back to, I think, the turnover. Ferraro had a rough time with the puck in the neutral zone, so he just lost it at his feet. And the Raiders tried to come out of the zone again and didn't. And now they'll be shorthanded.
Whistle stops play.
This will be the fourth power play for the Flyers. 1 for 3 in the first period. Their goal was a goal by Falloon. I think Bruce.
I think it was, I don't know if it was Driver. It might have been Ferraro.
Well, maybe. Well, this is Driver holding Semenov off the puck. Semenov away from the puck.
It was McTavish who was being held
by Ray Ferraro.
That's right,
on the right side. Yes. So
Ray had a rough time there. He lost the puck in his skates in the neutral zone and then got caught holding McTavish, the stick of McTavish. And Ferraro, as you see here, the puck about to go out of the zone, back in the zone, and Ferraro's got McTavish way up at the blue line. You see him holding onto the stick. Just a second too long. He just let it go as the arm went up from the referee. The Rangers shorthanded.
Ferraro for holding at 2:15. Fourth power play. Desjardins shoots. It's blocked. Graves has it and sends it down. Flyers 1-for-3 on the power play. Scored on their first one. Peter Svoboda carrying the puck. Now Eric Desjardins up front. DeMaio, LeClaire, and Lindros.
Good hustle by Healy. Stop the dump in. Flyers recover maybe here.
Lindros takes the pass. Pukuboom on him. Leach and Pukuboom with Messier and Graves for the Rangers. Lindros along the boards. DeMaio in the corner. Back for Lindros. Lindros looking. Pass through. Missed connection with Desjardins. Svoboda keeps it in. Lindros taken away by Leach. Joined by Messier. Leach turns, goes back to Bukuboom.
Bukuboom was going to the bench. The driver was coming off the bench. A quick change of mind.
Yeah. Bukuboom stays on now. Puts a hit on Lindros. LeClaire to the puck. Now for DeMaio. He's double teamed by Leach and Bukuboom. Puck comes loose. Presley looking for it. Works it up the boards and out. Presley with Sundstrom. Presley stopped by Therrien, but Sundstrom plays the puck. Good play by Nicholas Sundstrom. 30 seconds to go on the Flyers' power play. Presley stopped at the line. Sundstrom finds the puck, sends it deep. Here's Chris Therrien moving up. Flyers in. Bouncing puck stopped by Healy. Into the corner, played by Dan Quinn. Sets it up, out to Howler. Long shot knocked away by Healy.
It's the first shot by the Flyers on this power play and it's 5 seconds to go. Set up by Dan Quinn. This is by far the best penalty kill and the weakest power play the Flyers have shown in this game.
Team's back at full strength. 15:35 to go, second period, tied 1-1. Flyers 1-for-4 on the power play. Rod Brindamore moves in. Triple team. Left the man open, it's Balloon. The net has been knocked off, the whistle stops play.
Bruce Driver came back with Danny Quinn. Driver took him to the net, the net off the board. That's against the rules. Bo Samuelson sat on top of the boards for about 35 seconds. Finally, somebody came to the bench and he was ready to go. He's extremely alert, always ready, always thinking ahead. This is the last attempt as you see Driver take Quinn into the goal net, knocking the net off the mooring before the Balloon shot. Danny Quinn's had a good strong
first
game with the Flyers here. They just hope he continues with it and doesn't level off.
30-year-old Danny Quinn, who has played with 8 teams in the NHL. This is second time with the Philadelphia Flyers. Spent 1 year with them. Nordstrom able to clear it out. And Svoboda goes for it.
2-1 Chicago in Toronto. Kirk Muller has just scored for the Leafs.
Muller's first game this season with the Toronto Maple Leafs, having left the Islanders early in November.
The referee here, Sam, thought the puck went into the stands. It didn't. It caught the top of the glass. So they're keeping the faceoff deep in the Rangers zone. I think that's what happened here.
Free Dave Jackson.
The shot is, the puck is dumped in here. It hits Glenn Healy, goes to his left, up high. And I thought it caught the top of the glass. Stayed in the zone. There it goes, there it goes, there it goes. Oh, it just, it went out. My apologies. Oh.
The ice going on you?
No comment. Back to the eye doctor again.
Shot by Samuelson is a save by Healy. Good faceoff win by McTavish led to that point shot by Shel Samuelson.
Last time I was at the eye doctor, the Pittsburgh Penguins' Ron Stacko scored from center ice on me. They sent me to the eye doctor the next day.
Flyers breaking down. Romanek with the puck. Svoboda trailing. Open man McTavish. Saved by Healy.
And the more you see Glenn Healy play goal, the more you can appreciate his catching glove. That's a nice move here by the Flyers with their patchwork. And then it's a very tricky move by McTavish, who got away from his man through the backhand shot. McTavish got away from LaPerriere right at the blue line. See the blue line? See center ice? See McTavish with that tricky play on LaPerriere? Great play. And then a tricky backhand shot. And Healy read it beautifully. Backhand going to the top, and Healy was there. McTavish isn't quick, but he's smart. And he used his stick to twist around LaPerriere at center ice. Knocks LaPerriere off balance, and then he's home free. LaPerriere complained to the referee, and rightly so, but nothing called.
Brindamore gets a shot off that goes wide. Leach to the puck, moves it up. Graves tipped it out to center. Verbeek sends it in. Flyers out shooting the Rangers here in the second. Shots are even for the game. 1-1 the score. Brindamore against Leach. Now Dan Quinn. Circles. Blocked in front by Bukaboom. Messier's got the puck. Played by Brindamore. Pat Balloon stopped by Messier. And Leach comes back for the puck. Bukaboom moves up. Slides it to Messier. Now Verbeek turns. Quick shot. Knocked away with a blocker by Hextall. Tamayo stopped by Verbeek. Verbeek gets loose, gets to the puck. Tamayo stays with him. He's got a hold of him. Verbeek trying to ward him off. Tough battle. Centered by Verbeek. Comes all the way out. Karpovtsev couldn't take it. LeClair moves it to Lindros. Back to LeClair.
Oh, baby.
Big hit by Karpovtsev on Lindros.
Knocked the glass. In fact, it broke it right in half. Oh, baby.
Yow.
Those are the guys that pay $500 a seat to sit there, and he loves it. It's $500 to get glass knocked right into your lap.
Do you get to keep the glass? Maybe Lindros will autograph it for
us. He should.
We'll be right back.
We have an isolated look at Eric Lindros during the last shift. He goes to the boards here. Karpovtsev, who would love to hit him, look at that. Glass fractures, goes right into the seats. And again, those are the folks that pay $500 a pop to sit in the penalty box area. And they got rewarded for that. Almost something they might want to pay $1,000.
Almost had Lindros sitting with him.
Hey, Adam Sandler, Saturday Night Live, I just been told.
Oh, all right.
And old Mike Myers, he's a pretty excited guy.
Oh, Adam was having a good time.
Oh, look at him. All right, baby. Oh, look at the little youngster in the back there, though. That must have been a little bit frightening for those folks. The little guy. Oh, baby. Yeah, he's never been on TV before, so.
Oh, yeah.
He's actually, he looks like he's cut his thumb a little bit. Oh, that's up close and personal. And the little guy got through it. Wasn't frightened, which is good. This has been some game.
A little delay now as they wait to replace the glass. Want to welcome to our broadcast booth Ken Ackerman and Guy Mintz from Long Island. They bid to spend the evening with us in the booth.
And
at a charity auction at Cystic Fibrosis.
Both sitting back here sleeping. They've been up here with us. They're really excited. Right? kidding.
Al, does the mic work? Take it away, big guy.
Well, I want to know why everybody here is so happy, because they almost had Eric Lindros in their lap. You're bleeding. Why are you so happy about bleeding? Why?
Just before this period, I called my girlfriend up to tape this game because I have a feeling I'm going to be on TV, and look what happens.
Eric Foggy while we were here. Now, these are the $500 seats. How did you guys get them?
Well,
You got your money's worth. Oh, the glass is actually being in place right now. Well, guys, try to stay out of play. It must have been exciting.
Win the cup, Mess. It's all we want. Thank you.
I appreciate everything, Al. Thanks for coming down.
All right. Yeah. These are great seats, by the way, Sam.
That's not the guy from Saturday Night Live.
No.
Absolutely not. My apologies.
Good way. It's that scoop from ESPN.
Really?
Talk to those guys. Bad scoop from ESPN. Tommy McNeely, the producer. I'm going to have a long talk with him after this game. Maybe it was him. Maybe it was Tommy McNeely that got into the ring.
Oh, all right.
With Tyson, not his brother. He's lost his memory.
13:37 to go, second period.
Been some banging.
Yes, there has been.
40 quality body checks in this game, and we're not even at the midpoint. And there wasn't 14 in the Los Angeles Ranger game Monday night. This has been a lot of intense hockey.
Nemchinov out against Lindros. Nemchinov with Sundstrom and Presley. Karpovtsev and Samuelson. DeMaio, the forechecker for Philadelphia. Here's Nemchinov moving in. DeMaio takes it back. Rob DeMaio missed 14 games. Presley upended LeClaire. DeMaio missed 14 games with a cracked bone in his leg. Svoboda drops it off for Dykhouse. Good check by Nemchinov. Puck taken away by Presley. Dykhouse around for Svoboda, and a good hit by Presley.
On his former teammate.
That puck deflects up into the crowd, stopping play.
Talking about Svoboda, Svoboda and Presley both played for the Buffalo Sabres, who incidentally have lost Donald Odette. He's had knee problems. He's a quality kid, Sam, and a good hockey player, exciting player. He's playing on the wing with LaFontaine. Yeah. His knee's done for the season. He tried, but they're going to really miss him in Buffalo. There's the hit. Good, clean, hard hit by Presley, who moved in on Svoboda. As both teams are finishing their checks strongly in this game. Tough news on Donald Odette. He's an exciting player. Here's another look at him. You see Presley, he stopped skating, he glided in, took the body nicely.
Well, the Sabres will have to rely on Dominik Hasha. Score what they can and let Dominik stop them. They're leading 2-1 over Hartford up in Buffalo tonight.
Flyers just changed their defense pairing to get Therrien and Samuelson on the ice for Ferraro's line. They are saving Haller for Messier. Another penalty upcoming against the Rangers.
Maybe Ferraro again. Dave Jackson makes the call. Power play for the Flyers. We have an update coming your way from the MSG Sports Desk for that. Let's go back to Bob Page.
Sam, you mentioned the Kirk Muller goal. Here it is after ex-Ranger Tony Amati had scored 40 seconds into the period. Gilmore feeds Muller right in front. Backhands at home at 4:01 to cut the Blackhawks lead to 2-1.
John, I think Kirk Muller's going to help Toronto.
Big M, the big M. Frank Mahovlich, 427. Mm-hmm. That's what he's got on. Mm-hmm.
Another big M.
Well, that's where he wanted to play. Kirk Muller, he got there in a very different way. He's a much better person than he's been given credit for. And it's nice to see at least that he's started well with Toronto. It's an obstruction holding the stick penalty against Ray Ferraro. Boy, all the stuff that's going on in this game, and he's calling the obstruction holding the stick penalties. There's the battle along the boards with Flat. That's just a battle, that one, for a loose puck. I hate to see the flow of a good game get slowed down.
But you know what?
Obstruction holding the stick penalties.
But it was in the offensive zone, and Klatt's battling for the puck, and his stick was being held.
Power play Flyers. They're fifth. They're 1-for-4. Scored on their first one. 12:10 to go in the second period. 1-1 the score. Balloon and Leach the goal scorers. Here's Brindamore. Set up for Falloon, the shot blocked. Messier tries to clear and went right through Chris Therrien. Therrien and Haller on. Ekstall was pressed by Messier, fired it around the boards. Haller sends it ahead for Quinn. Quinn, Brindamore, and Falloon up front for the Flyers with Therrien and Haller. Leach took it away, stopped by Therrien. His shot deflected by Messier. Falloon moves it. Brindamore against Leach. Out to Haller. Falloon moves it. Therrien goes to play it. Picked up by Leach. Quinn's pass saved by Healy as he stops Falloon. Great save.
Danny Quinn made some nice plays.
Terrific.
Falloon is a shooter and a finisher, and he's just getting himself into position, and Quinn keeps feeding him. And Glenn Healy makes about his fifth quality catching glove save in this game. See the puck go in behind. Now Quinn will stay behind the net. He'll stay there. Gretzky's office. Messier's office. Now there's Falloon. See how the gun's loaded? He was already in position for the shot. Didn't get a clean one. Therrien, as you see here, pinched deep the defenseman. There's the pass and a quick shot. Again, Healy. He's had great concentration and a fabulous catching glove in this game. Makes another good save.
Joel Otto against Nemchinov for the faceoff. Otto looking for position against Nemchinov.
Now they're trying to get feet position.
Flyers have it. The quick shot went wide. The shot by LeClair. Otto, LeClair, and Lindros on with Desjardins and Svoboda. Good effort by Sundstrom along the blue line. Brought an offside on Philadelphia.
Nobody heard the whistle, I don't think, until just now. 38 seconds to go. As Semchinov and Otto had battled on the faceoff, the Rangers got scalped in Philadelphia on the draws, even though they won the game. In this game, the faceoffs haven't been as one-sided, I don't think. Again, Semchinov and Otto.
Semchinov wins it.
Not quite as intense in the neutral zone.
Ekstahl stops it. 30 seconds to go on Ferraro's penalty. Eric Desjardins moves up. Healy directs traffic. Driven around the boards. Blocked by Otto. LeClair behind the net. Looking. Back into the corner. Sundstrom chops it clear. Desjardins back for it. Nemchinov quickly on him. Outlet to LeClair. McTavish picks it up. Ferraro's back. Teams are at full strength. Here comes Lindros. Saved by Healy. And here's a break for Ray Ferraro. He moves it on Hextall. Saved by Hextall.
Man alive. What a game. What goaltending. Sun Healy, Rob Lindros. Great pass, I think, from Driver. And it was breakaway time by Ferraro. And this time it was Hextall. Wow. Watch here as the puck is moved in. Lindros on the backhand. Great save by Glenn Healy. And it's Nemchinov, not Driver. Nemchinov with the pass breakaway from center ice. Hextall dropped his right arm to give Ferraro the top side. And then he took it away. Puck doesn't sit down for Lindros, but he still got the shot off the shoulder of Healy. This pass, a beauty by Nemchinov. Watch the goaltender drop his right arm down just when Ferraro goes to shoot it. Ferraro goes high, and Hextall goes high with his arm to take away the top side. Look at Ferraro. He knew he wanted to go high. Hextall gave it to him, then they collided. What action.
Tough night for Hextall. Ray Ferraro.
Yeah,
he's hit a post, he's been robbed by Hextall, and he's had two minor penalties.
Oh, his wife better drive home.
1-1 the score, midway point, second period. Kevin Haller with a puck. Shel Samuelson brings it clear. Healy out to stop the puck. Back up the board. Samuelson there. Hit by Rovetai. Nordstrom for Kovalov. Crisscrosses with Messier. Two-line pass whistle against the Rangers. They'll bring it back. 9:45 to go in the second. Shots are even at 19. Goals are even, one apiece. Up on the scoreboard. Detroit leading San Jose 2-0 in the second.
Robitaille moved in and hit Samuelson. That opened up the ice, and you can see the pass from just inside the blue line. A good call by the linesman as the puck traveled over the blue line and the center ice line to get to Kovalov. Ferraro's starting to get a little more ice time now, it looks like, with Coley Campbell. He's making things happen out there.
Good numbers, over the last six for Ray Ferraro.
He prides himself as being a second-half player. As his game elevates himself, and he plays a stronger game usually in the second half.
Ferraro with a hit on Therrien. Verbeek trying to work it loose.
Rangers a change of sentiment against Sam.
Ferraro and Therrien, and finally a penalty has been called, and it's going to be on Philadelphia. Ferraro drew that penalty this time. Messier the extra man on it, a delayed penalty call. Ferraro fell down, and Desjardins drives the puck down the ice.
Once again, Coley Campbell has changed his sentiment, putting Ferraro on the ice with Verbeek and Graves. On the last shift, Ferraro, well, here you see the battle along the boards as Therrien, a big rugged defenseman, battles. Buffalo Sabres are taking a look at Therrien. They need some youth and some size. Here's a big young guy. Therrien's only 24 years of age, 6'4", 230. The Rangers go on the power play.
I don't think it'll be easy to pry him away from Philadelphia.
Never easy to make deals.
Anyway, Therrien goes to the penalty box at 10:46, and the Rangers' power play is their fourth. They're 0-for-3. second period. Rangers send out Messier, Graves, Verbeek, Leach, and Driver for the power play. Flyers, whose penalty killing is number one on the road, number two in the league overall, have been good on the penalty kill thus far tonight. Dave Jackson went over to talk to Colin Campbell at the Rangers bench. The referee now gets set. Messier and Otto for the faceoff. Otto, Codine, Haller, and Desjardins for Philadelphia. Leach. Stopped by Desjardins, cleared by Otto. Back for the puck, Bruce Driver. Leach brings it across, and an offside whistled on the Rangers. Leach went down. Ryan Leach, who has the Rangers goal, stretched his point scoring streak to seven straight games.
I think he's playing the best hockey he's played for the Rangers, except for in the playoffs 2 years ago. But most consistent from game to game to game to game, offensively and defensively. He is playing with as much confidence, I think, as a player can ever play with.
Nine points over the last seven, but 18 points over the last 12 games.
Now 27 years of age. That's generally when a player really kicks into the high impact time in his career, confident-wise.
Driver to Verbeek, his shot went wide. Driver to Leach. His shot deflected, saved by Hextall. That's a great save.
Great save. From the goaltender's point of view, when the puck changes direction and speed, both of them, it's an amazing reaction that a goaltender has to come up with to make the save.
Lee de Messier moves in and shoots. Scores! Mark Messier! It's a power play goal!
Oh, baby, what a shot. Usually Messier is on the opposite side of the ice, shooting low to the stick side. Graves was at the blue line, and he attracted attention by being stationary, standing there. It's like a magnet. It opened up the left side of the ice. See that? See where Graves is? He took both defensemen there. And look at the accuracy over the shoulder of Hextall. Driver to Verbeek, to Messier, over the shoulder, baby. And it's 2-1 Rangers. What a play on the rush, on the power play, and what a shot. Look at that. It doesn't get any better.
33rd goal of the season for Mark Messier.
Flyers don't want to put players on the ice. They're mad at the referee.
Yeah. They're upset over that penalty call on Therrien. They felt that Ferraro threw a punch at Therrien.
Yeah.
And he should have been penalized. Messier from Driver and Verbeek at 11:40. Messier with that goal has now tied Pat Verbeek for fourth place in the NHL in goal scoring with 33. Messier now takes over sole possession of fourth place in point scoring. He was tied with Gretzky and Sakic at 67 going into play tonight at 68 points now for Mark Messier. What a season. Puck around the boards. And the Flyers move up. So the Rangers lead for the first time. Here's Shel Samuelson. Quick shot blocked by Ulf Samuelson, his former defense partner in Pittsburgh. Lindros. Back pass. Svoboda. Nice move. Svoboda shoots. Scores!
Oh, yeah. What a shot that was. So all of a sudden we're tied at two. Le Perrier went down to block the shot. He went down head first. He's lucky he didn't get hit. But Svoboda showed some moxie, faked the shot, went around him, and then through traffic took the shot. Then the Flyers deep. Now watch Le Perrier here go down to block the shot. He's lucky he didn't get killed. You see Svoboda show some real calm play, and then with traffic, the high shot, very accurate like Messier's shot over the shoulder, and boom, we're tied at two just that quick. The Perrier's down, he's gone. When you're down and off your feet and don't get the job done, it opens up the ice. There's Svoboda. Look at that shot. May have hit somebody. It seemed to slow down or change direction a little bit. As DeMaio looks on, Svoboda's given credit, and we're tied at two.
Haller comes in right back to the Flyers. Quinn's pass into the corner. Falloon's got it. Quinn for Brindamore. Falloon around the net. Knocked away by Healy. So a quick response by the Flyers. Just 20 seconds. Make that 40 seconds. After the Rangers had taken the lead, the Flyers answer back. Svoboda getting his first of the season from Lindros and Samuelson at 12:20. Balloon able to clear the zone. Just under 7 minutes to go in the second. Game tied 2-2. Chipped up into the air, over the glass, and into the crowd, stopping play. 6:49 to go in the second, and the game tied. Well, the Flyers, who are upset with a penalty call, let the referee know about it, but they answered back by scoring a goal 40 seconds after 40. The Rangers had taken the lead.
And that really took the crowd out of it here. The crowd was absolutely going crazy with the Messier goal, his 33rd, on the Rangers' power play. But it certainly, with the Flyers scoring, calmed everything down here in the building. 6:49 to go in the second period. And now the Rangers, instead of the LaPerriere line against Lindros, they now have the Nemchinov checking unit out there.
Lindros seeing some double shifting here as Otto and Podin are out with Lindros.
I should apologize. It isn't the entire Lindros line.
Samuelson clears it out. Sent back in. Shel Samuelson fires out for Lindros. Cutting down the left side. Pulls up. Centering pass. Intercepted by Presley. Here come the Rangers. Presley, Karpovtsev, and Sundstrom. Karpovtsev, Sundstrom! And he shot it wide.
A great pass by Karpovtsev.
Presley fires. It's blocked in front. And lifted clear by Lindros. Karpovtsev to Sundstrom. Ekstahl quickly out to play it up the boards. It's knocked down. Lindros trying to move it ahead. Otto lifts it clear. Podin went down, and Leach plays the puck with 6 minutes to go in the second. Leach trying to hit Graves. Puck around the boards, and an icing whistled on the Rangers with 5:52 to go in the second period. On the Messier goal, Driver got an assist, and that stretches his point and assist streak to 7 consecutive games. He has 9 assists in the last 7 games. Streaks continuing for the New York Rangers. Pat Verbeek's streak is still on the line. He has a 5-game goal scoring streak. He now has a 9-game point scoring streak. Leach 7-game streak, and Driver a 7-game streak. Quinn against Messier. Leach has the puck.
Messier on the ice again, Sam, and I have to keep mentioning because the matchups are happening, but Haller on the ice again as the left defenseman. He and Messier have had a lot of run-ins the last couple of seasons.
Healy tried to move it up the boards. It was blocked. Graves against Balloon. Leach moves it around. Haller comes down to get it. Balloon against Leach. Graves to the puck, and there's Rod Brindamore to hit him. Good hit. Turnover. Balloon's got the puck. Bukaboom stops him. And Bukaboom with a good play to get it to Leach. McTavish tied up with Verbeek. Leach moves it up the boards and out. Messier stopped by Haller. Roughs him up a little bit. Haller and McTavish look for the puck. Messier. Now Bukaboom outlets to Leach. Jardin back for it. Boyd's Graves, McTavish.
Verbeek pulled down Haller near the net of Hextall. Verbeek will go. 2 minutes for obstruction hooking.
Power play for the Flyers.
The obstruction word is popping up in this game.
This break brought to you by Midas. Sixth power play for the Flyers as Verbeek is called for hooking at 15-17.
The puck now going up ice. You see Haller wanted to jump in the play, and you can certainly see that was a penalty and a good call
But if he said hooking, it sounds better than obstruction hooking.
All right.
you don't like that word, huh?
I hate it. It was certainly a penalty, though. Remember Haller in the playoffs last year?
Oh, yeah.
Jumping into the play, getting offense with the defenseman, getting offense, fourth man in the rush. That's Verbeek. Verbeek was trying to stop that, and it cost him.
Desjardins, Svoboda at the points for Philadelphia. Lindros, Leclerc, and Otto up front. Rangers with Leach and Bukaboom. Graves and Messier. Leach against Otto. Messier is there. Now Lindros, chopped by Bukaboom. Leclerc stopped by Healy. Good save by Healy. Puck around the boards. Messier over skates. And Leach helps out.
Glenn Healy has robbed Leclerc on at least three different occasions right near the goal net in this game.
Back come the Flyers. Leclerc is pass deflected. Samuelson clears for the Rangers. Peter Svoboda back for the puck. Svoboda on with Therrien, Brindamore, Quinn, and Paloon for the Flyers. Presley, Sundstrom, Driver, and Samuelson for the Rangers. Good play by the Rangers, and Presley try to send it down to Big Therrien. Yeah. As John mentioned, 6'5", just reached up and kept the puck in play. Kept the puck from going all the way down. Collar, Sundstrom's without a helmet. Quinn moving in, turning, pass for Brindamore. Couldn't get a shot off. Back pass to Therrien. Blocked by Samuelson. Excuse me, by Sundstrom, and it's cleared all the way down. 10 seconds to go in Verbeek's penalty. Brindamore intended for Paloon. Bukaboom gets there to clear. And that'll do it. Verbeek is back. Teams are at full strength. Flyers 1-for-6 on the power play. Rangers have killed off the last 5 in a row. Dykhouse to the puck. Checked by Nemchinov. Verbeek with a hit. Brindamore comes out with a puck. 2:25 to go in the second. Tied 2-2. Leach away from DeMaio to Bukaboom. Leach and Messier, the goal scorers for the Rangers. Pass intended for Nemchinov. Nice. And a whistle for an icing on the Rangers.
It's a good play by Hextall by not touching the puck, knowing that it was going to be icing. If he touched the puck, of course, it would have been nullified. It was just a heads-up play by the Flyers goaltender. Shot 22-21 in favor of the Rangers. Score tied at 2. 2:08 to go here in the second period. Hextall has to read the play as a goaltender. Is it icing? Yes, it is. Does it go through the goal crease? No, it doesn't. Can my player touch it first? Yes, he can. That all adds up to an icing. Just smart goaltending by doing nothing, really. Look at here as Glenn Healy moves out on Leclerc again. Goes right at him. Leads with his goal stick. The puck climbs right up the arm of Healy. And why? Healy has that short paddle on his goal stick, and he likes to reach with it. Made a good save.
The replay on the icing was from the MCS Cannon goal cam. MCS Cannon, let us show you the possibilities. On the last 3 Flyers power plays, we've only had 1 shot on goal.
Yeah, Rangers power penalty killing, pardon me, has gotten better as the game's moved along.
McTavish won the draw. Shel Samuelson moving down. Centering pass, and the shot saved by Healy. The rebound.
Goalpost. Goal
Healy's got it.
Podine hit the left goalpost. The first shot seemed to hit Healy or somebody. Everybody was diving and getting hit and reaching. Podine reached with the backhand, and I believe hit the left goalpost. Good effort on the draw by the Flyers. They're a good face-off team. Now they drive to the net because they have the puck. Bodine's shot there actually hit McTavish. Second one was saved. This one hit the post.
Yeah.
That time the glove hand wasn't quite quick enough. See the play as the puck is put in deep. All started with winning the face-off. As soon as the Flyers knew they won the draw, they just drove to the net. And the Flyers were a goalpost away from having the lead.
Talking to Glenn Healy this morning, asking what do you expect, how do you expect the Flyers to attack? He said down low.
Yeah, there's
a lot
low
down low.
Absolutely. That's where Leclerc's gotten all his chances.
Yeah. McTavish wins the draw. Samuelson shot saved by Healy. Long rebound. Moved aside by Leach.
McTavish did a good job there of anticipating the puck being dropped. He already had his body turned.
We should call it just sort of like cheating a little.
Yes. Bukaboom with a hit on Podine. Messier fires around for Ferraro. Minute 35 to go, second period. Tied 2-2. Leach moves across. Now Robitaille. Interesting alignment here. Ferraro, Robitaille, and Messier. Messier checked by Svoboda. DeMaio clears the zone. Following the second period, Al's special guest in the studio will be Mike Richter. We'll get an update on his status. Bob Page with an update at the MSG Sports Desk. And JD and I will look at highlights. So if you stay with us, Robitaille hit. Semenov trying to get it out of the zone was tripped up. Less than a minute to go in the second. Samuelson for Ferraro, but he missed.
Just about caught the Flyers on a change. They were changing. They had three players come off the bench trying to get back to the blue line. Ferraro read that and waited. The pass almost worked. And it was almost another breakaway. Ferraro's already had one in this game, and he was robbed by Ron Ekstall.
53.5 seconds remaining.
Take a look here as the puck is going to be moved up ice. Ferraro sees the change happening, goes to the other blue line. Flyers now, look at them all flying back. There's Haller, and here comes on the left side Desjardins. Messier back on the ice, Haller and Desjardins back on the ice as the defense pairing. Ray Ferraro has worked hard but not had much luck in this one.
Eric Lindros has had some good chances in the game, but has been denied.
The last Ranger game he played, he didn't get a shot on goal. In the first period here, he had three, and he's had at least one I know of here in the second period.
Sundstrom trying to get it to Nemchinov. Haller back for the puck, hit by Nemchinov. They battle for it. Haller trying to push it up the boards. Messier moves in, reaches in for it. And it's frozen in the corner for a faceoff.
You know, Haller, you see him in the hallway before a game. He's a thin guy. You know, he goes 6'2", but only 183.
Yeah.
He's a 6'2 defenseman, around 200 pounds. But he plays bigger than a 183 game. On that play, he had to take the hit because it wasn't going to be icing. And yet he didn't lose the battle for the loose puck. For some, I don't know, he grew up in Trochu, Alberta. It's farm country. Maybe he spent a lot of his youth throwing bales around or something. Well, you know, when it's been raining and you pick up those bales?
They're heavy, huh?
Real heavy. Real heavy, Schmoozer. He's strong.
You don't have to go to a sporting goods store to buy the weights. You can just lift the bales of hay.
That's exactly right. I used to do that for a buck an hour.
What'd you do with the money?
I was in the loan business.
Garfin's hit by Brindamore. LeClaire finds Lindros, gets it to Desjardins, a shot blocked by Graves. 5 seconds to go in the period. 1-1 end of one, 2-2 end of two.
A test of wills now. This has been a hard-fought game. Both teams have battled. Both goaltenders have been extremely good. It's just good. In particular, from the Flyers' point of view, they played a very strong road game for two periods. They've had trouble late in games giving up goals. We'll see what happens.
Each team has had the lead. It's 2-2 end of two. Al with Mike Richter when we come back. Sam, JD, and Al back at Madison Square Garden. 2-2 is the score. Let's take a look at some highlights. And the Rangers took the lead here on this.
This is the Lindros play.
Save.
Right. Lindros now has had four shots through two periods. And here he gets a good backhand shot. Glenn Healy with his catching glove side has made a number of great saves in the game. The Rangers then turned the puck up ice quickly. Ferraro on the breakaway. Hextall gave him the top corner. And then just simply took it away with a blocker. A big save by Ron Hextall. Ferraro's had a couple of great chances. Can't beat him.
Take us through the goal that gave the Rangers the lead.
The puck's behind the net here. Now you'll see Messier circle up the ice. He's to be picked up. This is the breakout on the power play. Driver on the puck. They'll stop it there for a second. DeMaio's job is to watch Messier. Driver's moving the puck to Verbeek, but watch the ice open up here, and I'll tell you why in a moment. As we move it ahead, stop it again. Now, over here, Adam Graves was. He now has skated over here, and he has both defensemen. DeMaio can't catch Messier, and you're going to see all this open up, and Verbeek hits him with a beautiful pass. In the NHL All-Star Game of the Skills Competition, Messier hit four targets with four shots. You can see why. What a shot that was. 2-1 Rangers.
This is a pretty good shot to tie the game here
sure
by Peter Svoboda.
It's smart. It's disciplined.
And as soon as he knew, he saw LaPerriere go down and leave his feet, he knew he had him. He went wide. The Flyers went to the net. Svoboda had room. And with all those people there, the puck went over the shoulder of Glenn Healy. Quickly after the Rangers had scored, the Flyers tied it up at 2.
2-2, heading for the third period. Should be a good finish.
We'll be back with all the action right after this. Here's the second period scoring summary. Mark Messier gave the Rangers the lead at 11:40 with a power play goal. 33 goals ties him for fourth in the NHL in goals scored with Pat Verbeek. Peter Svoboda, 40 seconds later, tied it up. Rangers have 23 shots, Flyers 22. Lindros line with 8 shots. Eric Lindros has 4 of those 8 shots. The Messier line with 8 shots as well. Flyers 26 hits, Rangers 29. Power play, Flyers 1-for-6 with 9 shots, but only one shot on the last 3 power plays. Rangers 1-for-4 on the power play.
Mark Messier's seen a lot of ice time tonight, John.
A lot of it killing penalties, Sam, to this point. 18 shifts, averaging over a minute a shift. So he's at 18 shifts, 20 minutes, but again, a good portion of it with the Rangers shorthanded 6 times. He's been awfully busy in that respect. Lindros has had a lot less ice time. 5.5 minutes less. That makes a big difference.
Now the Flyers have been...
Look at that. 9, 6, 7, yeah. 8. He taps the goalie's pads 8 times before the start of the game in each period. He wears 88. It's plastered all over him. You wonder why, huh? Look at that. 14-21. Messier 20-01. That's a great deal of difference through 2 periods.
Terry Murray's team has been tying. 4 ties in the last 6 games, 5 ties in their last 8 games, and 6 ties in their last 11 games.
Let's see where Terry's looking. He's looking directly to his left, which is exactly where the Rangers bench is. Now he's told his defenseman, with Messier on the bench, he just told Haller and Desjardins to change on the fly. The defenseman will change on the fly for the Flyers when they get the chance here, and then Haller and Desjardins will be ready for the Messier line.
Nemchinov, Sundstrom, Presley, Karpachev, and Samuelson for the Rangers.
Including Lindros, all 3 of them changed. They want Lindros, Desjardins, Haller to go on the ice against Messier. Now the Rangers change, and they come back with Messier's line. So here they have a shot at a shift with those guys on the bench. Now Therrien's gone on, Haller's on. So we've had all kinds of changes in 20 seconds here.
Podin checked by Bukaboom. Trent Klatt looking for it, hit by Leach. Leach looking for the puck. Klatt hit by Leach again. Klatt hit by Leach a 3rd time. Klatt stays with it. Good effort by Trent Klatt. Joel Otto taken away by Graves. Up for Messier. Kevin Haller drives it back in. Leach. Messier gets by DeMaio. He's bumped and gets into the zone. Feeds Verbeek. Long shot deflected into the corner. Desjardins able to get it to Haller. Flyers come out. Rob DeMaio moving in on Ulf Samuelson. Samuelson stops him. Graves looks for the puck. Lindros is there. It's out to Desjardins. He walks right in. Backhander. Score!
Oh, what a play. Another good play by a Flyer defenseman. You know, the Flyers did get the matchup they wanted here. It took patience, but they have Haller and Desjardins on the ice. They got Lindros on the ice. The Messier unit still out there, and Desjardins made a nice play. Svoboda, remember the play he made to go around LaPerriere? This time you'll see Desjardins make a nice play to move in and not panic with the puck. See the battle along the boards. Desjardins stays back. Here he gets the puck. Now watch everybody spread out, so he moves in. You see Lindros get loose, and I think Lindros will get credit for the goal as it was redirected through the legs of Glenn Healy. So the Flyers have the lead. Yeah, right there, the puck jumps and skips. The puck's done a lot of jumping and skipping in this game. That time off of Lindros, and I think he should get credit.
Lindros will get his 28th of the season, and the Flyers have the lead for the second time in the game. It's 3-2. Flyers led 1-0. Rangers led 2-1. Kovalov for Robitaille, offside whistled against the Rangers. 1:46 into the third period.
I would think that Desjardins certainly will get one assist. I don't know if there'll be a second one. DeMaio was over on that side of the ice. Yes, DeMaio does get the assist, Sam, along with Desjardins. There's the puck moved back by DeMaio. Now look at Lindros get around Verbeek here. Sneaks right around him. There's the shot and the deflection. Karpovtsev had taken his man out of the play. And the puck was redirected and chipped through the legs of Glenn Healy. Eric, you know, I'm sorry, Sam. The Rangers changed real well in those two games on the road in Philadelphia for matchups. The Flyers here have done a nice job changing their players to get their matchups that they want.
Rangers fourth line out there, Lacroix, Langdon, and Laferriere with Driver and Nordstrom. The goal was Lindros, his 28th from Desjardins and DeMaio at 1:26. And Eric Lindros, who came into the game tied with Brett Hull. This is Craig McTavish moving in. Backhands it deep. He was tied with Brett Hull and Peter Bondra for 8th in the league in goal scoring. Now has sole possession of 8th place. Semenov playing it deep. Good poke check by Healy as Driver was tied up with Russ Romanov. Laferriere for Lacroix. He cuts in, his shot stick to side. Nice save by Hextall. Bouncing puck, Laferriere against Semenov. Now Langdon. Well, Michelle Samuelson moves it up the boards, kept in by Lacroix. Battle along the boards. Lacroix plays it deep. Svoboda. Romanek can't clear, is blocked by Bukaboom. Romanek tries again, all the way down. This will be an icing on the Flyers.
Watching the Rangers do a lot of hitting here. Langdon with some checks, everybody on the ice. The Flyers not reacting to any of them. They're trying to play a disciplined third period. We have 16:57 to go. The Flyers have the lead and discipline.
Rangers fourth line did some good work in the offensive zone.
Well, they had a shift where they really wanted to try and grind it out, bang, and hit some people, which they did. But the Flyers didn't react. Svoboda gets nailed by Langdon. No reaction. Langdon goes across here. Another big hit on Romanek. No reaction. With the lead, you want to play discipline.
Hextall made a save on Bukaboom and a penalty called on the Flyers. Dan Quinn took down Ray Ferraro.
Ferraro, the Rangers won the draw. When you win the draw, you drive to the net in the offensive zone. Ferraro did that. Quinn stayed with him but dragged him down as the shot was taken. See, Ferraro on the draw here with Quinn. Rangers will win it as a team. See there, back to the point now. Ferraro drives to the net. Quinn stays with him and just hauls him down to the ice surface. So good effort by Ferraro, winning the draw, driving to the net, and then yanked down. So the Rangers have a chance here now to try and get that offensive flow going.
Dan Quinn in his first game as a Philadelphia Flyer has an assist. He's sent to the penalty box for holding at 3:09. Fifth power play for the Rangers. They're 1-for-4. Messier has the power play goal. Brindamore with a clear. Leach back for the puck. Leach and Driver, with Messier, Verbeek, and Graves for the power play. Driver makes a nice move. Slides it down the boards. Kevin Holler gets there to clear. Otto, Podine, Holler, and Desjardins for Philadelphia. Leach heads up ice. Now Messier, Verbeek, back to Messier. Back pass comes out of the zone. Two Flyers collided.
Otto and Podine, and they were both thinking breakaway.
Leach toward the net. Hextall decides to stop play. With Verbeek right there. 1:08 to go on the power play.
Well, we thought Hextall looked real sharp early in the game, and he has continued to be that way. Here's the puck hitting somebody going out of the zone here. Right there. And then all of a sudden, two players thinking breakaway. Driver would have probably gotten back if Bodine and Otto collided with one another. You know, Otto in this game, seeing a lot less ice time than what we saw in the past.
Yes.
I think they asked too much of him. I mean, he was brought to Philadelphia as a big money free agent. But he's not an offensive player. He's a good face-off guy, great penalty killer, good checker if you give him a role. I think the Flyers had him doing too much. Getting Quinn takes some of that ice time away from him, but makes him, I think, a better player, and them a better player, or a better team.
Kovalov with Robitaille and Ferraro on. Robitaille in the corner against Lindros. Peter Svoboda is there. Lindros and Brindamore. Karpovtsev sets up Leach for the shot. Save. Hextall. Long rebound to Brindamore. Now Lindros comes down with the puck. Brindamore bearing down on Leach. Leach and Karpovtsev have to work to take it away. Here comes Leach. Lead for Ferraro. Ferraro against Desjardins. Leach moves in. Robitaille gets it across to Kovalov. Back pass to Karpovtsev. Now to Leach. He turns. Wrist shot. Save. Hextall.
So the Rangers wanted. They had three flyers out at Karpovtsev.
Karpovtsev shot. Save. Hextall. The rebound. Grabbed. Given away by Svoboda. He actually closed his hand on the puck, but it wasn't called. Leach taking it back.
There's a trip roll,
yes,
baby.
Robitaille with a trip. No call. Ferraro had it taken away, and the puck cleared out by the Flyers. Brindamore moves it. DeMaio moves in. Back pass intercepted by Kovalov. Kovalov moves in with Robitaille. Kovalov shoots wide.
Man, what a rocket, but he missed the net. What a play by Kovalov, but he missed.
Back the other way. Teams at full strength. Flyers 2-on-1. Podine is hit by Driver. Holler is deep. He's checked by Kovalov.
Kovalov hasn't had a lot of ice time. It looks like he wants it now.
And a penalty upcoming on the Rangers.
To Kovalov. It's a holding call. Well, Alexei Kovalov made a great steal in his own zone, headed up ice, had the chance for the big-time shot. Looks like Hextall was lifted up on it, and he just missed the net. Then he came back to battle in his own zone, ended up grabbing a hold of somebody, and the flow changes again.
It was Haller who was deep on the play.
Let's Kovalov read the play here. Goodbye. He's on his way with Haller coming back at him along with Desjardins. Here he just misses. See, Hextall appeared to be beaten on the play. And then Kovalov lost the puck there, and that cost him big time because it's an odd man rush. Here comes Haller, number five. He'll battle for the puck. He's up ice because of the turnover. And Kovalov stays with him. And again, Haller works his way off the boards. Works his way off the boards, and then he's hauled down. Again, works his way off the boards. Podine battling. There goes Haller, and Kovalov lost position and grabbed a hold of him.
Kovalov for holding at 5:48.
One of those years. He was within a hair of scoring to give the Rangers a tie game. Now he's in the penalty box hoping the Flyers don't score.
It's a big one here. Brindamore's shot is blocked. Graves clears. Graves, Messier, Samuelson, and Driver for the Rangers. Therrien and Holler with Brindamore, Falloon, and Quinn for the Flyers. Flyers 1-for-6 on the power play. They scored on their first one. Kevin Holler takes it deep. Puts it in front, steer to side, saved by Healy. Oh, a big save by Healy on Pat Falloon.
Falloon had his hands in the air. He thought he had scored. What a setup. He fired the puck, but it went right into Healy. It wasn't an accurate shot regarding inside the goalposts or underneath the crossbar. It went right into Healy. This Kevin Holler's everywhere. He's played himself a fine game. There it is. And oh, look at this. Falloon can't believe he's double-checked, double-looking to make sure that it didn't go in. Haller towards Healy. Healy chips the puck, and there's Falloon. He thought he had himself a gimme. Haller, because Kevin Haller has played one fine hockey game.
Fans didn't react to this save because they saw Falloon raise his arms, and they thought it was a goal.
Falloon, his arms are up, and then it's one of those ones. Oh, drop. Oh, my, I got to get him back down real quick. It wasn't in. Oh, baby.
Peter Svoboda to Eric Desjardins. Eric Lindros out for Svoboda. Lindros, LeClaire, and Otto on now for Philadelphia. 1:20 to go on the power play. Svoboda moving down, picked up by Samuelson. Desjardins to LeClaire. Messier checked him. LeClaire gets away toward the net. Save, rebound, save, Healy. As he stopped Otto on the rebound.
Otto had about three shots at that. Bukaboom now very unhappy with Otto. And I'm looking at Jackson, the referee. He's leaning on the goal net, watching from a great seat exactly what's going on. Bukaboom was really upset because he had his helmet knocked off. Otto had at least three swipes at the puck. The first one was a great leg save, a kick save, and a beauty, as the MCS Cannon goal cam will show. Look at Otto in front. The left leg makes a save right there. Second shot a save, third shot into the glove. And then Otto pulls the helmet right off of Bukaboom, and that got his blood boiling a little bit. Again, one shot, there's Otto with a second, Otto with a third. And then the waltz begins. No penalties, right, Sam? Or just they still are one with Kovalov, and that's it?
That's it.
No obstruction there?
You're using that word again.
Kind of disappeared for a while, but it's resurfaced.
Kukubov tried to drive it around the boards. It deflected off the net, but then caromed all the way around.
Funny, my buddy Brian Burke heard me, but he must not have because he's sitting over in the press box.
Oh,
I'm glad he's not listening.
He doesn't have the audio feed, huh?
I hope not.
Loose puck, and Kukubov drives it out. Paulie Campbell using the tandem of Kukubov and Ulf Samuelsson paired on the penalty kill here. Lindros. 35 seconds of the Flyers' power play. Oh, Lindros hit three times with a stick by Presley. No penalty there. Lindros to Desjardins. Peter Svoboda moves in. And a save by Healy. Svoboda knocked down. A chance in front for LeClaire. And the whistle stops play.
Bowling for Dollar.
Oh, man.
Bowling for
Flyers.
It's tough ground. Samuelsson and Otto. Bukaboom and LeClaire. Presley had been on Lindros. It's a war in front of the two nets. The Flyers, this is one of the better games I've seen them play. Oh, and Otto with a little shot there to the mouth of Samuelsson. That may cost him 2 minutes. Maybe not either. Five shots on goal so far on this power play. There's 18 seconds remaining on it.
Flyers had had only one shot on goal on their previous three power plays.
It's been a war around the front of the net. Samuelsson there knocked the helmet off of LeClaire. Otto gets involved with Samuelsson. Bukaboom flattens LeClaire.
Oh, man.
No obstruction, though.
A lot of tackling.
Oh, it's nice to watch this from up here. This has been a war down around the goal nets. A
couple of rabbit punches by Samuelsson. A cross-check by Bukaboom.
That's hockey.
Final seconds of the Flyers' power play. This will be an icing on the Flyers. And that's a good break for the Rangers with 6 seconds to go in the Kovalov penalty. 12-17 to go in the third. Flyers with a 3-2 lead.
Problem in this game for the Rangers with a streak on the line here, but it's... here's the little... A little parting shot. Problem is that Messier has played so much in killing penalties, and it's been a hard penalty kill night. You know, it's been a battle. Looks like Joel Otto's getting some type of attention to one of his hands on the bench. Training staff working it out.
Ferraro and Quinn for the faceoff. Ferraro and Robitaille on with Leach and Driver.
Actually, with Otto on the bench, Sam, it looks like he was replacing one of his contacts.
Oh, okay. Rob DiMaio out with a puck. Kovalov steps on. Teams at full strength. 3-2 Flyers. 12:05 to go in the third. Flyers 1-for-7 on the power play. Kovalov going off. Beat coming on.
Players changing all over the place here.
Healy knocked down by Quinn. Healy chips it again. Ferraro plays it. Nice move by Ferraro. Knocked down by Therrien. Beat trying to play it. And Brindamore able to clear it out. Leach back for the puck. Leach and Messier, the goal scorers for the Rangers. Balloons, Svoboda, and Lindros for the Flyers. Lindros, the go-ahead goal on a deflection here in the third period. Leach got a piece of it. Karpovtsev trying to control it. McTavish on him. Giveaway. In comes Semenov. Shot blocked.
Semenov was slamming a stick on the ice, and I think Karpovtsev thought it was a teammate.
Yeah. The beat with a quick shot, steered aside by Hextall, but it was offside. Rangers were offside on the play. 11:10 to go in the third. Ron Hextall has made 27 saves, and the Flyers lead. Flyers have played a hard, tough game here on the road. They're unbeaten in their last four road games, 2 wins and 2 ties. As they come in here, seeking revenge on the Rangers, who had beaten them twice in Philadelphia. Glenn Healy slow getting back into the net.
That. He almost dropped the puck. Glenn Healy was still at the top of the faceoff circle. Now he's back and away to go.
Driver lifted in. Desjardins.
If the Rangers' Mark Messier line can't get the offense going, and they've relied on that line all season. It's time somebody else pulled through for them.
LaPerriere against Svoboda. They both go down. Nemchinov knocked down by Podine. Driver sends it down. Nemchinov tied up. Driver shoots, deflected across.
LaPerriere is hurting. He's trying to stay on the ice for the shift, but I think he's hurting. He throws a hit. If he's hurting, he should go off to get somebody healthy out there.
Driver took out Podine. Trent Klatt played it toward the net. Nordstrom trying to stay with Klatt. The puck up the boards. Shel Samuelson's got it. Past Langdon and Klatt. LaPerriere bumps with Podine. Klatt with a shot that's blocked. Another shot intercepted in front. Nemchinov has the puck. Leaves it for Langdon. Takes the shot. Kicked away by Hextall. Langdon again. He's roughed up. Tarrion in the corner. Nemchinov along the board. The puck out to center. Samuelson looking for it for the Rangers.
LaPerriere in a lot of pain on the bench. He got tangled up with one of the Flyers early in his shift. And then he finally got off the ice. He's hurting.
Kovalov trying to cut in. Flyers break it up and clear the zone. Chris Tarrion takes over. 9.5 minutes to go in the third. 3-2. Flyers leading it. Shel Samuelson. Messier back for the puck. Long pass. Hits Graves. Graves against Desjardins. Graves shoots wide. Messier to the puck. Swings it around the boards. Old Samuelson comes in. Kovalov in the corner. Knocked down by Halleck. Try to center. Bounces back to Kovalov. Shot. Hextall. Score! Adam Graves!
Oh, baby, what a save Hextall made, and Graves was right there for the rebound. And we're tied up at 3 with 9:04 to go.
Rangers just kept working, John.
Yes, they did. Kovalov helped out. He didn't quit on it. Here's Karpinen making a good play. Look at this save. Oh, he didn't stop it. It went wide. My apologies. And Graves stayed there. The pass from behind the net right on the stick from Messier to Graves. Look at Messier get to the loose puck. He knows where Graves is. And you see Hextall never could recover. Karpinen made a great play to pinch in and find the puck to keep it alive. We're tied up.
Hextall made a great effort on this shot that went wide, but it actually took him out of the play.
That's exactly right. See, Karpinen there. That's the key play. That's the key play to keep the play alive, and then Messier to Graves. Remember, the Flyers scored how many seconds after the Rangers had tied it up at 2?
40 seconds.
So this has to be a smart shift for the Rangers.
Bukovo moves it to Leach. Ferraro moves out with the puck. 3-3 the score. Now the teams have taken turns coming from behind. Flyers led 1-0. Rangers tied it, went ahead 2-1. Flyers tied it, went ahead 3-2. Rangers have tied it 3-3. Verbeek. Pass Robitaille. Ferraro to the puck. He shoots, save Hextall. And Hextall holds on. The goal, Graves is 17th from Messier and Karpinen at 10:56.
That's Karpinen, that's LeClaire. LeClaire's got to watch Karpinen. Let's see if he does. Now just stop it there. LeClaire's over too far. Karpinen will sneak in. As he sneaks in, he finds the puck, and LeClaire loses him. That got the play alive for the Rangers and ultimately led to the tying goal against the Flyers. Sam, it's a playoff atmosphere.
Oh, absolutely.
Here.
Fans alive. 8:10 to go. Centering pass. Graves looking. Taken down. Nothing called. Kept in by Driver. Now the line is Messier, Graves, and Kovalov.
Well, we've seen Verbeek for a while now on the Ferraro line and Kovalov on the Messier line here. And this is the threesome that led to the tying goal.
Matthias Nordstrom in his first game back since suffering the shoulder separation in Edmonton. Desjardins across. Haller moving it to LeClaire. He's stopped. Desjardins stopped by Driver. Here comes Graves. He was hooked. He moves across. LeClaire ties him up. Messier tried to put it in front. Lindros took it away. DeMaio to Lindros. And taken away by Graves. Good play. Kovalov with Messier. Messier fakes. Shoot save made by Hextall. Shel Samuelson whips it around. DeMaio. DeMaio moves in. His shot deflected by Karpetsev way up into the crowd. Play stops with 7:05 to go on the third. 3-3 the score.
So you wonder about the Rangers. You wonder about their big line. The big line getting the goal there. They'll give them, and I'm just trying to add it up here, 83 goals in the season. 83. The Legion of Doom line, of course, without Renberg tonight, they have 77 goals on the season.
Well,
that Messier goal, two assists. He just keeps on moving, no matter what the other team does against him.
This is his 20th multi-point game of the season.
Wow.
To lead the team. 3 points in the game for Mark Messier, giving him 70 on the season. He is fourth in the league in scoring.
Ferriero seems to have recovered. Checking his legs out. This is where he got hurt. Slammed into the boards there by Svoboda, and he never recovered much from that hit. He's been on the bench since, and I think he's hurting.
Nemchinov wins the faceoff.
Quick changes. Lindros goes off in favor of Quinn.
Wolf Samuelson drives it, knocked away with a blocker by Hextall. Shel Samuelson moves it for Dan Quinn. Rave it away. Kripik. The big shot. Wide.
Rangers make a quick change to get their defense pairing changed so they can have Samuelson for Lindros when he comes back. Man, these coaches and teams have changed extremely well.
They are maneuvering.
It's a real chess match.
Dan Quinn with a puck. He's got Brind'Amour with him. Nice move. Good play by Bukaboom to sweep it away. Off the boards, knocked down by Pat Balloon. Deflects out of the zone. 6:20 to go in the third. Tied at 3. Both teams have scored goals in each period. Verbeek, Ferraro tipped away. Bukaboom shoots. Save. Hextall, he's got it.
He wasn't quite sure. See how it
dropped out. Yeah.
Yeah, he was looking behind him. You can always tell when the goaltender's not sure. When their head starts turning right and left, looking in behind them. Ron Hextall did make the save. The Rangers have now had 35 shots. 12 here in the third period. Good battle. The Rangers starting to win a lot of battles here. Ferraro loses the puck, but Bukaboom jumps in. And the shot's on net. Verbeek's there looking, and he's taken out of the play nicely by Desjardins. Again, you start winning loose battles like this. Robitaille with a good forecheck, and you see Verbeek, Ferraro there, and then again you see the shot. See the puck sit down in behind?
There it is.
Maybe he's that close. If Desjardins let Verbeek go, if he let him go, it would be 4-3 Rangers, but Desjardins made a good play staying with Pat Verbeek.
Messier and McTavish. Messier, great play. Here's Nordstrom, wrist shot, knocked down by Hextall. Messier lifted McTavish's stick and almost knocked him down with his force. Centering pass, knocked away, batted at by Otto, and cleared out of the zone.
Ranger defense doing a lot of pinching at the offensive blue line.
Therrien able to send it into the Rangers zone with 5:40 to go in the third. Tied 3-3. Healy almost got himself in trouble.
A little bit casual back in behind the net.
Good play by Podine.
And Nordstrom going at one another bit. The last game here with Los Angeles, Coley Campbell changed the centerman on the first two lines. Here he's changed the right wingers in this game. Glenn Healy looked, and just a hair too late as Podine did make the good play. Wouldn't that have been something?
Mm.
But it wasn't.
5:35 to go as you take another look.
It was close. In a 3-3 game. 5:35 to go. We've had a good one. Now, it's the big train. Eric Lindros on the ice and the Rangers counter with Samuelson and Karpetsev.
Sundstrom takes the faceoff. Lindros wins. Desjardins toward the net, knocked down by Sundstrom. Nemchinov turns, gets it out to Presley. Here comes Karpetsev. Deflected. Quick shot by Presley is stopped by Hextall. Desjardins for Lindros. Quick pass to DeMaio. Now Desjardins coming forward. He shoots wide. Ulf Samuelsson got a piece of that. Samuelsson moves the puck. Presley bumps with LeClaire. Can't clear. Kept in by Svoboda. LeClaire tees it up. Fakes. Wrists it toward the net. Save. Rebound wide by DeMaio. Good play by LeClaire. A giveaway by Shel Samuelsson. Presley moves in. Samuelsson gets back with a long reach to break it up. Kukaboom to Leach. And in the Flyers zone, they go with 4:40 to go in the third. Tied 3-3. Shel Samuelsson. Odin. Odin's had an active game, John.
Yeah, he's a good hockey player, Sam. He's very quick and is extremely strong. He has played active.
This is an icing on the Rangers. Desjardins with a touch. 4:19 to go in the third. The Rangers have come back to tie it. Pat Verbeek has had an assist in the game, has not scored a goal. His five-game goal-scoring streak on the line. He stretched his point-scoring streak to 9 straight. Pittsburgh has defeated Ottawa 4-3. Jacques Martin's debut as head coach for the Senators. A tight game.
It was close.
Damian Rhodes made his debut as the goaltender for the Ottawa Senators in that one. Right here, Rangers can't clear. Desjardins stopped by Kovalov. Kukaboom tried to lift it clear, but lifted it up into the crowd. 4:11 to go in the third period. As John mentioned, this game is being broadcast back to Russia, and we want to pick up the feed of the Russian announcers. Let's take a look and listen. Well, the captain has done it again, Mark Messier, and the Rangers lead 4-3. How do you say that in Russian?
Brassai?
Something. He shoots, he scores.
Brassai, Messier.
Rangers lead for the second time, both on goals by Messier. Kovalov with a beautiful breakout pass. And number two, Brian Leach, beats Messier. Both Messier goals in this game have come off the rush. And as he had a great second half to this game.
John, the man's a human highlight film this season.
That wrist shot must just, I don't know what it does to goaltenders, but it flips and finds its way into the net. And the Rangers lead with just under 4 minutes to go.
Mark Messier, wow. He does it again. He's had a four-point game. And the Rangers lead 4-3. The second time the Rangers have led in the game. Messier's 34th, his second of the game, from Leach and Kovalov at 16 minutes. And the crowd going wild. 3:25 to go. LeClaire against Karpovtsev. Good play by Karpovtsev. Moves it around past Ulf Samuelsson. Flyers try to keep it in. They do. Lindros along the boards. Karpovtsev battling him. Samuelsson checked by LeClaire. Nemchinov against DeMaio. Nemchinov knocks DeMaio down on top of the puck. Comes loose to Lindros. In front, Desjardins tied up by Sundstrom.
That's a great play by the rookie Sundstrom, staying with his man. Remember, Karpovtsev stuck around LeClaire. This time Desjardins could not sneak around Sundstrom. He did his job beautifully.
Bukaboom moves it around the boards. Stopped by Therrien for the shot. Saved by Healy. Out to Therrien again. Blocked by Verbeek. Ferraro to the puck. Ferraro moves in. Ferraro backhander wide. Leach. His shot. Save. Hextall. McTavish with the outlet. Semenov was taken down. Leach with a hip check on Romanek.
McTavish was knocked down. 2:10 to go. They're going wild here at the Garden.
I think it's the most entertaining game of the season here.
Oh, what a hit by Verbeek on Svoboda. It's a penalty. Penalty upcoming on Verbeek.
Oh, baby.
Healy makes the touch. Power play, Philadelphia.
Face off in the Rangers zone. Verbeek wants to discuss this one. They call it boarding. It'll be interesting. Speed means nothing with the hit, but if he was still skating and didn't leave his feet, then it's a penalty. If he didn't, it's a rotten call. The puck's at his feet. I disagree totally. The puck was at the feet of Svoboda. Of course, we looked at that in slow motion. When the puck was there, you got to take the body. I disagree with the call here, in my opinion. The puck is at his feet. He moved in. He was gliding at time of impact. Coley Campbell's telling the referee to look at the scoreboard. He's really hot. Boarding's a call at 18:04 of the third period. I disagree with the call.
Oh, I think Coley Campbell clearly does, too.
What about you? What do you think?
I think you got a good case.
Svoboda loses the puck. That causes him to put himself in a prone position. The puck's there. He was gliding and never left his feet. That's a bad call. And it's too bad because it's an important part of the game. There's the hit. It's not his bad. It's not Verbeek's fault. Svoboda turned because he lost the puck.
Right.
So that puts Svoboda in a prone position.
It's not as if Svoboda had moved the puck and was standing with his back to
him. Absolutely not. Svoboda lost the puck. Anyway, that's the way it goes. That's the referee's call. And now it's up to the Flyers to score and the Rangers to stop.
Rangers' penalty killing unit put to the test. Lindros won the draw. Centered through to Jardin, Svoboda, Quinn, LeClaire, and Lindros for the power play, and Graves with a clear. Graves and Messier, Driver, and Samuelson for the Rangers. Here's Lindros. A penalty on Lindros for hooking and pulling down Bruce Driver.
Oh, he's mad. It's almost as though the referee got himself into trouble. Here, Lindros is really hot. I don't know what happened. I saw a Driver go down. And it's now 1:30 to go, and we'll have even up play.
It was a tug on the arm.
Was it? Boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. It's too bad. It's a young referee. And, you know, I remember when Detroit had the call on Coffey, we said that was a bad call, and it helped the Rangers. It's like everything here has magnified. Lindros reaches in. And he pulls Driver off balance as the stick got into the hip. Driver was pulled off balance. Hooking the call at 18:30. Lindros really hot.
So now it becomes a 4-on-4 with a minute 30 remaining in regulation time. The Rangers leading 4-3. What a game this has been.
It was a one-handed hook. Lindros had one hand on his stick, but he did hook into Driver. Driver went down. Boy, oh boy. You wonder if the last call meant something with this call.
It may have.
Yes.
It may very well have. So now, we'll see how the Flyers play it without their star. And if and when they will pull Ron Hextall for an extra skater.
Here's
LeClaire moving in. LeClaire around the net. He shoots. It's deflected across. Hextall's gone to the bench. 5-on-4 for the Flyers, who trail 4-3. Brindamore cuts in, shoots, score! Flyers tie it! Wow! What a play by Rod Brindamore!
Well, I agree. Danny Quinn's the player that came off the bench in favor of Ronnie Hextall, which gave the Flyers an odd man advantage in the Rangers zone. And patience by the Flyers with the puck is shown now on three different goals. One by Svoboda, one by Desjardins making the play for Lindros, and then on this one, look at Brindamore, fake the shot. When you leave your feet and don't make the play, you're in trouble. And I think with two Flyers standing, one on each side of the net, I think Glenn Healy was thinking about spreading out. Instead, the puck went right through his legs, I believe, to tie it up at 4. Flyers didn't quit. Svoboda with the play. Brindamore now has a player on both sides of the net. Healy spreads out. The puck goes right through the legs. We're tied up.
Brindamore's 14th at 18:51. Still skating four aside. 1 minute remaining in regulation time. Nemchinov shoots wide of the net around the boards. Otto tied up with Karpovtsev. Brindamore for Desjardins. Knocked down by Karpovtsev. Desjardins trying to keep it in. Rangers get it out.
Well, he's a good player. Desjardins very seldom makes a mistake. Can't understand Montreal giving him up.
Well, Montreal's given up some good defensemen.
Oh.
Who they could use back right now.
Svoboda, Haller, Desjardins, all of them have played for Montreal at one time or another.
Brindamore again. Cleared aside. 20 seconds to go in regulation time. Podine took a punch from Graves. Podine was hooking Graves. Graves gave him a shot.
If nothing happens here the rest of the way, the Rangers will start with a short power play in overtime. Somewhere around 20.
Oh, Messier fell down to Mayo. Shoot, save, Healy. Rebound, save, Healy. Oh, he stopped Podine on the rebound.
What an effort by Podine to get to the rebound.
And here we go to overtime. What a game.
Everything. The blue line jumped up, knocked him over. The high shot off the shoulder. Watch Podine fight off the check and get the backhand shot. Glenn Healy makes a fabulous save in the closing seconds as the game tied up, stays tied up at four. What a contest.
This has been something to watch, and we still have overtime coming up.
Back at the Garden, poised for overtime, you're looking at Bruce Driver, who visited with us after the first period when he was drinking down this strange-looking concoction filled with glycogen. I said, Bruce, what's that for? He said, well, it's not for now. It's for the third period or beyond if we need it. I get the feeling that might be the case. Well, he was right, Sam and J.D.
I wonder if you put a lemon in with that, get a couple of flour things, or maybe some celery, a little pepper.
I don't know.
Glycogen or something. What was he saying? What did he say? Glycogen?
Yeah.
I never heard of glycogen. Have you? We used to drink water.
Well, this has got some sugars for energy, John.
Oh, okay.
Flyers.
Other stuff after that.
Flyers are 2-1-10 in overtime this season. The two wins, one at home against Vancouver. Therrien got the game winner. One on the road at Florida. Haller got the game winner. The loss was at New Jersey in overtime. The Rangers are 1-0-8 in overtime. That win was here against Detroit.
And that was a power play goal in 3 seconds. Verbeek comes out of the penalty box. The Rangers will have a 26-second power play. So let's take a look-see.
Messier, Graves, Driver, Leach for the Rangers. Messier wins the faceoff. Here's Verbeek on. Rangers with a man advantage. Leach heads up ice. Flyers have Otto and Podine with Haller and Desjardins. Ekstahl swings it around. Driver is in deep. Verbeek, it pounces past him. Otto's got the puck. Lifts it clear. Podine after it.
Well, he's been everywhere. You're right, Sam. Podine's had a good one. A lot of players on both teams have had a good one. And we've been entertained. Lindros out of the box.
Team's back at full strength. 35 seconds into overtime. Here's Driver. Quick shot that's blocked by Haller. This has been a playoff-type game from the outset. And the teams have gone back and forth. Flyers led 1-0 and 3-2. Rangers led 2-1 and 4-3. DeMaio trying to get by Ulf Samuelsson. Sundstrom cleared the puck. Shell Samuelsson sends it ahead. Healy stops it, fans on it. Lindros centers, tipped wide by LeClaire.
Healy may have stopped it, Sam. He bailed himself out of it.
Wow. Awfully close. Presley swept aside by Svoboda.
He's starting to remind me of me, the way I used to handle a puck.
Presley shoots over the top. LeClaire bumped by Nemchinov. Whoa, Lindros sent Karpovtsev flying. Presley with the puck. He shoots, save, rebound, save, Hextall as he stuffed Sundstrom. Svoboda fires out. 3:15 to go in overtime. Leach moves across, knocked aside by Shel Samuelsson. Here comes Brindamore against Bukaboom. And Kukubum stays with him. Healy moves the puck up for Robitaille. Verbeek. Wrapped up by Therrien. Taken down by Therrien. Puck around the boards. Robitaille after it on the near side. Verbeek in the corner. Couldn't get it out in front. Balloon comes out with it. Met by Ferraro. Balloon moves in. Puck rolls behind the net. Good check by Robitaille as he stayed with Brindamore. Quinn was knocked down by Bukaboom. Out in front, it's shipped over the top. Balloon picked away by Bukaboom to Verbeek. 2:25 to go. Ferraro drives it. A tough bouncer.
Oh, yeah, that thing dropped about a foot and a half.
Karpovtsev trying to lead Graves. Graves against Haller in the corner. Kovalov moves in, now Graves. Samuelson plays it deep for Kovalov. Can't get out in front, denied by Shel Samuelson. Moved up the boards, old Samuelson pinches in. Flyers clear the zone, a minute 50 to go. Karpovtsev with Podine after him. Graves fires it across. Svoboda plays the puck. Now to Jardin. Up for Trent Klatt. Blocked by Leach. Finds the puck. Desjardins back for it. A minute and a half to go. Sundstrom. With Lindros forechecking out to Kovalov. Nice move. Kovalov moves in on Therrien. Kovalov turns. Looking. Cutting. Shot it wide.
Oh, just wide. Kovalov needed that. Just to help his season.
Therrien. For Lindros, and he is sent flying by Bukaboom. Bukaboom to the puck, able to move it out. Sundstrom, here comes Leach. 1 minute to go. Leach goes all the way. Shot it wide, puts it in front, and it's carried through. Lindros fires out. LeClaire against Karpovtsev. Karpovtsev takes it away. 45 seconds to go. Knocked down by Haller. Played by Ulf Samuelson. Shel Samuelson clears it. Trent Klatt is slowed down. Klatt finds the puck. The whistle stops play.
Finally, hand pass in the neutral zone. Rangers have had, it says, 3 shots that have been registered in overtime. The Flyers won, but it seems like the Rangers have had more. They missed the net on 2 or 3 different. Now, here, I want to bring something up here.
Go ahead.
I shouldn't, but I will. These two teams have battled so hard. If somebody scores here in the next 33.4 seconds, Bukaboom moves in. Lindros tried to jump to avoid him and went down. He wears braces on both knees to protect himself. He got mad at Bukaboom. Anyway, these teams have battled so hard.
Right.
Somebody scores, somebody gets 2 points, the other team gets none. Just a little debate here, a little question mark. Both teams should maybe, after a great regulation, get 1 point and they battle for the other one.
I'm with you.
You agree?
I agree.
Just a thought.
I don't have a problem with that.
Nothing wrong with discussion. And I'm not even sure where I stand on it, but I think when you see a game like this where they've had such great efforts, it's almost like you should be rewarded for that first 60.
Good play by Lindros. And Karpovtsev with a good play. Lindros to Quinn. And it really got a piece of it. Lindros. Deflected across to Desjardins. Toward the net. Stopped by Ulf Samuelson. Messier trying to work it up. Ulf Samuelson to Messier. Fires out to Sundstrom. Brindamore to Lindros. And that's it. It's a tie. Wow. So the Rangers' unbeaten streak on home ice continues. It reaches 22. Rangers pick up their 67th point of the season. The Flyers have now played 5 ties in their last 7 games. They are 1-1-5 in the last 7.
I think the Flyers are very happy with their effort on the road. The Rangers certainly got into some type of battle. Both teams deserve A for the efforts in this one. It was exciting all over the place.
What a game. Ron Hextall made 38 saves. Teams took turns leading and coming back. Flyers got the first goal, led 1-0. Rangers got the next 2. Flyers got the next 2 after that, led 3-2. Rangers led 4-3, and the Flyers tied it. Here are the 3 stars.
The big boys played well.
Yes.
Messier, Leach, Lindros.
Len Healy number three star. Eric Lindros, the number two star. And with a four-point game, Mark Messier, the fourth leading scorer in the NHL. Two goals, two assists. He gave the Rangers the 4-3 lead, but a great play by Rod Brind'Amour with the goalie pull with just over a minute to go, tied it. And that's how it ends, 4-4. Post-game wrap-up is coming up.